and this mouth guard.
I'll get my own. Thanks.
The fifth season is when spirit for the game gets passed down. That's why we're proud to support over 5,000 teams.
Hey! 100% drive. Hey! 100% passion. 100% effort. But women in sports get only 5% of the attention. Hey! Canada's dairy farmers believe women in sports should be seen and heard loud and clear. With Fueling Women's Champions, we're shining a light on women athletes at every level. Hey! Join us. Hashtag champion her.
Kimmy, you do know that there's only 4 seasons, right?
Then how do you explain the way kids wish away the summer?
Best mates.
Or how families happily vacation in Winnipeg in January because that's where the tournament is. So you see, Miss Woods, there is a 5th season, and it's the best season in Canada.
So you're talking about hockey?
Oh, it's more than just talking, Miss Woods.
Scotiabank is proud to support over 5,000 teams in Canada's 5th season.
Énergie. 100% passion. 100% effort. Pourtant, les femmes n'ont que 5% de visibilité. Les producteurs laitiers canadiens croient que les athlètes féminines devraient être vues et entendues haut et fort. Avec Nourrir la passion du sport féminin, nous célébrons les athlètes féminines de tous les niveaux. Joignez-nous à Vive le sport féminin.
Turn up the heat. Here come your Calgary Inferno!
Welcome to CWHL Live at Winsport, home of the Calgary Inferno. Today's Canadian Women's Hockey League between your Calgary Inferno and the Boston Blades. The CWHL and CWHL Live would like to thank the Canadian Dairies Farmer Fueling Women's Champions Program for their valued support in presenting the CWHL streaming in 2015-16. We'd also like to thank league sponsors Scotiabank, Sportsnet, Winsport, Bauer, Tim Hortons, Toyota, Molson Coors, the Globe and Mail, Bridgeforce, Porter, Gongshou Gear, OMGs, the Calgary Flames, the Toronto Maple Leafs, the Montreal Canadiens, and team sponsors the Calgary Old Time Hockey Players Association, Alberta Athletic Therapists Association, Deckel Doctors, and Sockbox.ca. Please be sure to check out the CWHL.ca for all the latest stats and information on the CWHL, and enjoy the game. Marshall, how are you doing tonight?
Oh, man, other than fighting off this cold, I am doing unbelievably awesome. The long-awaited offseason finally now coming to a head for the Calgary Infernos. We're getting ready here, just minutes away from player introductions and puck drop. And I got to tell you, the team that they are icing this season is, I think, going to be right on top.
It definitely gets you a little excited to come out and watch some hockey here, as we are going to be back with you after the opening ceremonies.
Two on one here with Campbell, looking to pass, shot. There's your goal, tying goal. Her second in as many games is Brittany Esposito. Up behind for Dion. Johnson manages it on the backhand, muscling around inside post to make it 3-all. League-leading scorer, Rebecca Johnston.
Well, here's a chance for Calgary. I'll get back to that in a moment. They slash in and score. What a great finish. The Inferno make the most of that one.
One shot saved by Brian off the post there down.
To be honest, with my ankle, I thought it was going in.
Irwin watching that come over her shoulder. Centering pass to Johnston with a great one-time touch.
Out of the rebound roulette with it now, pushing it up to the point. Long shot, Cudmore leads it. Deflection, I believe that was awesome. Did it go off to
A stick and tape-to-tape pass right over Sarah Davis.
Yeah, a lot of talent.
Roulette breaks through. Partial break here. Dom back. Shot can't get off. Amazing save by Brian Sproul.
Can't see a much nicer save than that.
Wise. Esposito. On the back end from Esposito. Just under the arm and in, making it Cunningham.
All rebound given up. And Cunningham cleaning that up, making no mistake to give us a 2-1 score. With a
pocket pick just inside the blue line there by Bram. And that scores! A great pass across. Toronto with an early chance. Now Calgary trying to answer back here in overtime. They just over a minute. Rebecca Johnston near circles, skates, stick handles, takes it behind the goal. Centers, and it's in! Cudmore finishes it off with the one-timer. Toronto pick up a single point, but Calgary come back after giving up two third-period goals and win this in OT.
As time has expired here, 3-2 is the final score. Calgary.
The Inferno players are getting set to take the ice here, led by number one returning goaltender, Kathy Desjardins. Took last year off and is back for another season with the Inferno.
Yeah.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, there you have it once again, your Calgary Inferno team for the 2015-16 season. A few players missing off the ice tonight in Bridget Laquette, who is off finishing her degree. And of course, other players as well, not quite out there tonight in action, but still representing in Megan Mickelson, as well as Rebecca Johnston. And both teams are set here. And we will be right back after the national anthems.
Inferno and CWHL fans of the Boston Blades will welcome you too, because, well, we're gracious hosts here in Calgary. Ain't that right, Marshall?
It is. My name is Marshall Stevenson, play-by-play for this evening, voice of the Calgary Inferno, and joined doing color tonight with me, as typically always, is my sidekick, Jeff Stevenson. We've been waiting a long time for this. Starting lineups introduced there. Jeff, it looks like you got something you need to say here.
Nope, not yet. I was just getting the page ready.
Just getting the page ready. Well, it's been a long time coming, and we can tell by the crowd that we're not the only ones that have been excited by this. I'm looking at this the arena here, and this is the fullest I've seen it.
Well, we've definitely got the seats full. There's still room downstairs in the standing room zone. Those tickets, of course, once it sells out upstairs, it's $10 down there. So a great deal to come down to Winsport. If you're listening at home, rather than stay at home, come join us. Come here, see it in person. As The teams might be waiting a little bit for the smoke to clear from the ice. Someone might have got a little bit overzealous with the smoke machine. Don't know who that was.
Yeah, I wouldn't know either. I would imagine it was you. But hey, who really truly knows that?
Yes, that would have been me.
You're going to have to adjust the handle there because we're standing and they want to cut to us apparently on a live view. I don't know. That might be a little low. The camera adds 20 pounds, right?
I thought it was 40.
Oh, well. Yeah. Anyways. We are just a few minutes away here from puck drop at Winsport at the Jones-Snyder Arena.
And yes, we got the players out there skating around the ice circa that old Stanley Cup championship in Boston when the old garden had the issues with the power and the humidity and the fog settling on the ice, and you had the Oilers and the Boston Bruins skating around trying to clear the fog off the ice.
I can smell the fog up here now. So it looks as though the
with
ice
all that
has
speed down there, they can probably clear it pretty quickly.
Well, I would imagine that they can as the players are getting set here. Let's go through starting lineup for the visiting team Blades. Between the pipes is Genevieve Lacasse. In front of her, Tara Watchhorn, as well as Drew Burns on D. And up front, Sadie St. Germain, Aaron Kickham, and Christina Brown for the Inferno. Webster, Cunningham, Bram, Campbell, Cudmore, and of course Brian, as we are underway here on the 2015-16 season for the Calgary Inferno, as the puck at Jones-Snyder here brought in just offside by the Inferno. This is going to come outside the Boston zone to the left. We are end-to-end action here from our broadcast vantage point, and we're actually in the corner a little bit more than normal, so we're going to try and position to see all the action as you're tuned in live on CWHLLive.com. And the puck is back in the Boston zone, cleared and knocked away by Lacasse as Watchhorn behind her net there. Backhands it into the close corner here for us. Campbell for the Inferno now. Skating along the blue line there. Keeps it in, makes a move, taken down. And we got a penalty coming up to Boston here as it looks as though it was Brown that touched the puck there to get the stoppage of play. And it's going to be St. Germain going off for 2 minutes. And the Inferno on their first power play.
Yeah, early start to the season for the power play unit, and that penalty there definitely created by the speed of Jessica Campbell. Had a step around her coming around the edge there, and the penalty was taken to stop her from getting the zone, but we'll see what the Inferno power play can do here.
And face off to the right of Lacasse, blocker side, as Wickenheiser and Brown set to face off.
And we're just working on getting the penalty up on the score clock there. There we go.
And faceoff won by Calgary. Back to the point for Pierre. He pushed down the half boards there. Wickenheiser back up top. Carry down for Wick. Wick takes a shot, and Lacasse with a pad save steered into the corner and cleared up the zone by Tremblay. For the Blades is Davis with it now. Back at her own blue line. Over to Campbell, missing it wide there. Bram going in for it. And knocked up into the player benches there. As we got a number of different number changes for the Inferno this season, most notably, of course, Jenna Cunningham giving up that number 22 to all-time Canadian Haley Wickenheiser, of course.
Well, I think what it was, too, is that she wanted to honor Emily Berzins with number 14 as well, so.
And there we go, is Calgary now.
A wrecking ball.
Wickenheiser coming in down the left wing, centers the pass off the skate of the Blades and steered wide. Kept in the Blade zone by the Inferno along the half boards here. Davis and number 7 Esposito. See, it's gonna take a bit with these numbers for me as Boston clears it down, goes off in a line change with a minute 10 left in the power play for the Inferno. Dumped the length of the ice. Inferno called on
icing.
It helps
too when you can see the actual numbers too, as there was a one in front of that 7 that was buried in the boards there as they're fighting along there. It was Bailey Bram fighting for the puck there.
And my name is Kathy Desjardins of the Calgary Inferno. Go to calgaryinferno.net/insider to sign up to become an Inferno.
And face off to the right of Delaney Bryan. And that's won easily by the Inferno as Cudmore with it now behind her own net. Cuts out down the left side up to the Inferno blue line, pushing it up as brought in onside here. Centering pass out front. Jenner unable to connect on that one for the Inferno, as Boston's number 15, Myers, sends that the length of the ice with 45 seconds left in the Boston penalty kill here, as the Inferno looking to make a move here. Coming down the right wing with a good head of steam is Sonye. Left there at half boards for Esposito. Knocks off. Esposito with it. Breaks out to the middle. Up to the point there for Cudmore. Try to get it down. And knocked off her stick by Myers as Boston gets it out. Cudmore with it now at her own blue line. Right wing pass there, bringing it in is Jenner. Jenner battling down low with Watchhorn. No strangers to each other there on the same team for the national squad. Turnbull drops it off down behind the net. Sonier on the backhand, just wide to the glove of Lacasse as Watchhorn clears it up with just 3 seconds left. And an odd bounce off the end boards there. Bryan almost a risky play there as Blades, player taken down to the opposite end of the rink, slides awkwardly into the boards there, but breaking down now, making a move there is Bram.
And we're just going to get a whistle as the player makes their way back to the bench for Boston. So Marshall, we've seen the first power play come and go for the Calgary Inferno. It is an 0-1 start, but some great pressure, some great chances there. A couple nice shots on goal and some good scoring chances. Coach Reed's got to be happy with that start for the power play, even though they didn't get the goal.
Agreed. 17-15 in the first here left to play. Still scoreless at 0 as the Inferno are applying pressure here down in the zone with Bram to the right. On the backhand here, cuts out in front. Shot, rebound, given up. Pushed away with her stick by Lacasse as Keefe with it now. Up for Shea. Shea down, gets center ice and dumps it in. As back to grab it now, Takeuchi for the Inferno now. Trying to get it up and out. Managing to do so there. It's in the Boston end. As DeMasi just tripped up a little bit there. No call on that one as it's dropped at center ice. Long dump in shot by the Blades, and Delaney Bryan staying sharp there, keeping that one out and still scoreless here as Wickenheiser cutting down through the middle. Duncan picks her off on that centering pass. Haig with it. Makes a move at the blue line, circles back, tries to get the pass off, tied up by Watchhorn. And the Blades now making it up down the right wing. Murphy with it, gaining into the Inferno zone around the back of the net. And with it is Pieri passing it around over to Haig. And up over in neutral ice territory here as Duncan battling with Wickenheiser. Down low here, Sonia with it. Can't get it on the backhand as Burns knocks it off her stick. And Wickenheiser in the corner. Haig with it now. Over to Duncan for the Blades, trying to get it up and out is Murphy with it at her own blue line. Down the right wing in front of the player benches. Off the board, skates around number 8, Crom for the Inferno. And in the corner with Pieri, both players down. Crom with it now, trying to get it out. Does so over at the half boards there, kept in by the Blades. Shot on net, steered wide. Pieri with it, circling around, pushing it up down the right wing. Squirts out at center ice there. And number 18, DeMasi, just losing a slight edge there, but managing to stay on that. Out of danger here. Stepping in is Sonia with the shot there.
Well, that was Captain
Jenner.
Captain Brianne Jenner is being named the captain of the Calgary Inferno earlier today. Definitely a deserving candidate as the first round draft pick and a strong international resume at her fairly young age already.
And this faceoff to the right of Lacasse, won by the Blades, as behind the net was Tremblay with it, up over to St. Germain, up through center ice, and that pass broken up by Webster of the Inferno, but dumped in there by Kickham around the Inferno net. Held in at the blue line by Watchhorn. Down along the close half boards, end-to-end action here with 14:55 left in the first, still scoreless as the Calgary Inferno and the defending Clarkson Cup champion Boston Blades are still scoreless at 0. Lots of action at the opposite end of the rink here as Jenner with it now makes a move at her own blue line off the boards and just loses it at center ice there as Kickham brings it back in, dumps in and picked off. Rink wide pass and dumped in down, knocked away easily by Burns for the Blades. Burns behind her own net now. Shoot heavily by Davis there. Curio with it now. Curio and Burns battling. Davis looking for it, can't get it. Stepping up though was Takeuchi from the blue line. DeMasi with it now, over to Keefe. And held in along the half boards there by newcomer Japanese player Aoki. And Keefe with it
for Kane Aoki
for the Blades. And dumped back in. And icing hand goes down. Watchhorn with it now for the Blades around the back of the boards. Up through center ice, just out of Kirio's reach for it. As it's rink wide and picked up now. Turnbull at center ice Spins, dumping it in there for Bram. Bram can't get to it. Watch Horn there first. Off Keefe as she's falling. Campbell holding it at the blue line. Campbell, high slot. Shot high over the net. Centering pass out front. Shot and a save by Lacaze. Dumped behind the net by Watch Horn around the close boards here. Held in. Campbell steps off. Slot shot off the shin of Kate Gray for the Blades. As Calgary applying the pressure here. Shots 4-1 with 13:09 in the first here. Bram now shot backhand. Loose puck down in front. Lacaze covers up, paying close attention on that one to get another stoppage of play.
Well, the early theme for the Boston Blades has been their superstar, Genevieve Lacaze, has got to be on her game for this team. And against a firehouse team like the Calgary Inferno, pun intended there, no shortage of needing to be spectacular tonight either.
And shots 5-1 for the Inferno right now. And the Boston player waved out. As Hag with it for the Inferno now. Over to Sonia there with a long hard shot and a nice pad save by Lacaze as Wickenheiser with it now at the blue line just outside, dumping it in close corner around the boards there. Hag with it. Hag backhand blind pass out front at the blue line. Cudmore taking the shot just wide. Wickenheiser right through the crease in front of Lacaze and can't get act on that one. Shot just dumped on the net into the corner here. As Sonia with it, picked up by Myers for the Blades, up to Murphy. Murphy makes a move, avoiding a check, and dumping it in to the Inferno end, pursuing that puck. Picked up, battled in the corner there. Opposite end of the rink for us here. As Watchorn steps off the boards, takes a shot from the point. Bryan with a save, backhand, pass right behind the net there. And Wickenheiser gets it up. Out to her own blue line there as Hag takes it and just dumps it in off on a line change. Back for the Blades is Tremblay with it now on the left side here. Held in by Esposito. Gloved down there but knocked out. On trying to get it back in. Back over to Esposito. Esposito shot using Aoki as the screen but high over the net. And it's wide here as Myers gets it up to center ice but picked up by Takeuchi, who couldn't connect with the Inferno players. Battling, bringing it in now is Esposito. Esposito down the right wing, makes a move, shot forehand. Gets a shot off, but no damage done there as it's picked up now on the clearing attempt. Bring it in, Inferno, centering pass over to Esposito, makes a move and passes it. Can't hang on to it to Jenner, who had a yawning cage there. If that would have connected with 11 minutes left here in the first period, still tied at zero. Both lines off on change. Lacaze with it now, trying to clear it out. Held in by Pieri at the blue line. Turnbull off the half board. Centering pass over. Just a little too hot for Davis' stick. Back to the point. Pieri shot. Tip down in front. Saved by Lacaze. And Kickham trying to get it up and out. Inferno coming hard. Crom on the boards. Can't get it. As Turnbull with it. Spins over to Pieri. Pieri up top, dumping it down, and Lacaze dives for it for a much-needed stoppage of play for the Blades to settle down a little bit here.
And with that, the CWHO would like to express thanks to our sponsors, the Canada's Dairy Farmers, Scotiabank, Sportsnet, Winsport, Bauer, Tim Hortons, Toyota, Molson Coors, the Globe and Mail, Bridge Force, Porter, Gong Show Gear, and OMGs.
And face-off to the left of Lacaze, won by the Blades, down in the low corner here. Turnbull with it now off the boards. Up to the point for Pieri, back down half forward. Turnbull off and centering pass over there for Kirio. Can't connect on the backhand now. Behind the net, Davis with it. Davis trying to get out front. Lacaze pushing it away with her stick. Davis gets the shot. Lacaze didn't know where that one went, but it stayed out off her helmet. As now with it, Turnbull, with that. Unable to get it out or keep it in. And Keefe trying to make a move. Bram with it back for the Inferno now. Pieri pushing it down the right wing. Bram trying to make it in. Off the boards does so. Campbell, long centering pass over to number 14, Cunningham. There's the one that'll mess me up there. Cunningham with it now. Making a move. Backhand forehand shot. And Lacaze squeezing those pads. And another stoppage of play. 9:43 in the first.
Well, of course, this end-to-end action also brought to you by the Calgary Flames, the Toronto Maple Leafs, the Montreal Canadiens, the Calgary Old Time Hockey Players Association, Alberta Athletic Therapists Association, Deco Doctors, and Sockbox.ca. Genevieve Lacasse, what can you say about her so far?
Keeping the Blades in this one for sure, even though we're still scoreless here at zero each side, but just getting her gear reworked a little bit there after taking that one off the helmet.
No sense of humor with her either, as having some fun we'll talk about in the intermission.
All right, one by Bram. And Webster trying to keep it in, being battled with by number 18, DeMasi there, as it's out to center ice. Cunningham with it now for the Inferno. Circles back up to Bram. Bram right down in the middle of the zone. Drops it for Cudmore's long shot wide to the left of Lacasse. And Lacasse paying attention there as it's battled down in the low right corner here. DeMasi and Campbell with it. And Bram down there as well with Watchhorn. Puck is off the boards. Bram Myers picks it up now. Up the middle, kept in by Cudmore, but Watchhorn lifting it up and out. And icing waved off there as the teams are off on a line change. Webster behind her own net. Delaney Bryan only seeing two shots so far this evening as we're 8:50 left in the first period. Shot by Wickenheiser, deflected wide to the right of Lacasse. Wickenheiser looking for her rookie first CWHL goal. There you go. As Delaney Bryan covers up on the rolling puck. We're going to get a faceoff in the far end.
It's hard to think of Wickenheiser as a rookie when it comes to the experience that she has in this game and the international resume.
I just wanted to make sure I could say rookie, or Wickenheiser the rookie, at some point in this season.
And of course, you notice Aon Hurst chest as well, named an assistant today as well.
Absolutely deserving of that. As the Inferno trying to clear the zone, Wickenheiser up in front of the player benches off the boards, but not able to get it in deep enough as Burns easily cleared that out. And length of the ice, we're going to get a good solid icing call here.
My name is Megan Mickelson of the Calgary Inferno. Go to calgaryinferno.net/shop to purchase.
Are you pushing the buttons too early?
No, I haven't touched the button the second time there. It just seems to want to go on that one. I don't know what's going on with those.
All right, face off to the right of Lacasse, won by the Inferno. As back, the blue line dumped in low. And St. Germain trying to clear it out and does so, just stepping over the stick of Aoki. As Wickenheiser battling for it down low there, getting into the zone is Brown. And pick it up in the corner. The Inferno now trying to clear it up. Knocked down by the Blades. Centering pass and a lone St. Germain. If she was able to connect on that, only had Bryan to beat. Wickenheiser bringing it in now. High slot down and a shot from Sonya. There's your goal to make it 1-0. And there's Haley Wickenheiser's first point and Jill Sonya's first goal.
Well, what a nice pass
CWHL
across
career.
There. As I'm sure we'll get a highlight of this momentarily here. Here it is right now, as you can see. Crossing pattern there, draws the defenders over to her. Nice pass across, and the one-timer, Sonya wasting no time to bury that. And not going short side either, going across the far end of the net, knowing Lacasse would be hustling across. So using Lacasse's eagerness against her there to capitalize on that one and give Calgary a 1-0 lead.
And 7:46 left to play here in the first period. As Boston winning that faceoff, Watchhorn with it back in front of Lacasse now with it. As we're all getting our hockey legs back on us with the DJ playing. A little bit too much excited there. As Jenner with it now, centering pass over, backhand. And that is Lovell, another rookie with another quick goal, 7:27 here. Wow, that was an amazing pass and goal.
And that puck quickly disappears into the glove of teammate Esposito, who grabs it to put aside for Elena Lovell's first goal as in her CWHL career. And very quickly here on the 9th and 10th shots of this period, it is now 2-0 for the Calgary Inferno. And Genevieve Lacasse, not much she could do on either of those two plays there.
Definitely not. As we're set for the faceoff once again here at center ice. And Lovell with it now, just dumping it in on the back end into the close corner. Lacasse behind her own net, pushing it up. Half-boards there. Myers with it now, pushing it up. We got to figure out who's actually wearing number one tonight. Carditi is listed here as a goalie, but number one's got that jersey on, and
could be playing out. You never know.
That's true. You never know. Although I did see Carditi actually on the bench there in her black Blades Classic jersey.
A jersey shortage of something there, so
yeah,
threw that one on. So
We'll figure out who it is a little bit later. Here is Cudmore with it now. Up to center ice there for Turnbull, bringing it in down the blue line, trying to get it through. Watchhorn breaking that up. Shot, loose puck down in front. Rebound, Lacasse covering up.
Let's try another one of these here, see if it plays all the way through here.
My name is Erica Crom of the Calgary Inferno. Go to calgaryinferno.net/kidsclub to sign up for the...
All right, we're getting some
little technical difficulties.
Early cut on those, but hey, you know what?
You get the point.
Yeah. CalgaryInferno.ca/kidsclub. We got an awesome kids club started this season for, what is it, $25?
$25. And gets the kids in every home game, every regular season home game, and 50% off the playoff games. Pretty good deal.
Yeah, as we are back underway here. As the Blades at center ice there, off the boards now. Bring it in there is Tremblay. Shot glove, easily saved by Delaney Bryan there on just the fourth shot of the period for the Boston Blades.
And you mentioned the hockey ladies getting back there. As this score right now is still not updated yet on the screen there, so it is 2-0. Don't adjust your TV sets or computer monitors. Two quick goals there by the Calgary Inferno have them up 2-0 with shots 11-4 in favor of the Inferno.
And this faceoff coming to the blocker side of Delaney Bryan in the Inferno end at the opposite end of the rink here. And faceoff won by the Blades. Back to the point, blocked off the skate as the Inferno trying to get it. Campbell coming in, knocking off the stick of Duncan. Now Cudmore with it, pushing it down just low and to the left of Lacasse. St. Germain up the right side now as it's Farrell with it. And slap pass right in the middle. Couldn't connect with the streaking Blade player as the Inferno trying to clear it out. 5:55 left in the first period here. 2-0's your score as it's back. And there's a, was that a goal? No. Campbell with the shot, looked like a goal. Everybody thought that it was, but the puck is still out.
There's no instant replay in the CWHL currently. So even if we looked at it, no goal.
And Takeuchi with it, pushing it up. Wickenheiser breaking down the right wing here, drops it off for Sonia, and a shot right on the chest of Lacasse, who holds on for that one. Looking like she's in a little bit of pain down there, but 5:20 in the first.
And CWHL Live is presented by Canada's Dairy Farmers, fueling women's champion program. With women's sport making up less than 5% of sports media coverage and women's sport getting 0.4% of all sports sportsmanship money, Fueling Women's Champion is dedicated to turning around these statistics by directly tackling challenges that women and girls face sports through their partnerships with organizations. CWHL, looks like we do have a goal.
So that is a goal by number 20, Jessica Campbell. And that one did go in. I thought that it did. It bounced off back of the net.
I'm sure
so
Logan
tight.
Downstairs can get a replay of that one for us so we can see it for sure here. But as I said, no instant replay in the CWHL, but the referees on the ice can converse and make that call afterwards when they have the chance to talk about it, just as they did. So looks like the referees would have got that call right and did the right thing by being organized with it.
So we're going to call this 3-0 now for the Calgary Inferno as we've got 5:45 on the clock to play. And faceoff won by the Blades. As that one tried to clear by the Blades player and up into the Inferno bench. As now it's up.
And back up here as we get set at the blue line for the faceoff here. A great start for the Calgary Inferno, up 3-0 here. Shots 13-4 with only 5:38 left in the first period. That's right, the first period. 3 goals, first period.
In West Calgary is where the Inferno come to play. Okay, I won't even try it.
You know what? Go ahead. That wasn't too bad. Here you go.
No,
I'm
not gonna try this at all, man. We got 5:32 left in the first period. We're feeling good. The Inferno are up 3-0 here on the home opener with I'm gonna call this a sold out crowd.
Yeah, I don't see an empty seat there. So
this face off, I see one, two in front of us.
Yeah, but people were there.
That's because we're
right
though.
There. See?
Oh, okay, they're there. Yeah. As play back underway here, Wickenheiser in off the glass, down low below the icing line. Hag trying to get out, broken up by Gray as it's up at center ice there. Webster with it now. Check that, Aoki back now. Sonia trying to get it in, unable to do so. As it's neutral ice now and broken up by Gray. Wickenheiser bringing it in on the backhand, knocked off her stick. Sonia trying to keep it in, can't do so. And pushing that back. As Pieri dumping that in. And icing waved off there. As Tremblay over to Keefe. And up to Myers. Myers makes a move. High slot makes a move, trying to get around Krom and just loses the handle on the backhand. As in the far left corner from our broadcast location, battling for the puck now. As Jenner dumps it up the right wing there for Esposito. Esposito looking to pass all the way. Battle of the sevens, Myers and Esposito down low in the corner here. Sorry, that's Burns. And a centering pass out front, and Lacasse gloves onto that one quite easily for a stoppage of play.
And you talk about the battle of sevens. Of course, Brittany Esposito wearing number 19 last year, switching to number 7 this year as Erica Krom slides one up to 8. Esposito, of course, honoring the famous number 7, Esposito.
And this faceoff won by the Inferno, back to the point. Shot Lacasse with a save. Loose puck down in front, cleared off into the corners. Murphy with it now, trying to get it out. Esposito with it now, down low, level, centering pass over to Jenner as she knocks in another goal, 4-0 for the Calgary Inferno.
Well, that was some very, very nifty passing. No doubt about that one.
There's your nifty, your first nifty of the season.
No doubt about that one, as Genevieve Lacasse right now is just shaking her head and not sure what else she can do to try and keep her team in this game. As the patience there by Lovell, Allery scoring a goal earlier to not shoot that puck, but dish it back over to Jenner, who had the yawning cage for her first CWHL goal as a Calgary Inferno.
There
not
you go.
First CWHL goal, because of course she's played before.
And the faceoff won by the Inferno now as Webster with it, pushing it up the left wing and breaking in to try and grab it was Davis, but Watchhorn there first, Watchhorn Davis. As Turnbull picks it off, backhand from her knees, just wide to the right of Lacasse. As a bunch of players battling for it on the Boston Blades half boards there. Webster lifting it up high over everyone. Davis with it now behind the Blades net. Watchhorn battling. As Turnbull with it now for the Inferno. Trying to clear it wide over to Webster, and that was broken up by St. Germain. As bringing it down now, Curio is shot wide, but Lacasse intelligently hangs onto that one with 3:18 left to play here, 4-0 Calgary Inferno in the first period.
Well, it's been a lot of pressure by the Calgary Inferno, but by no means is Boston out of this just yet. Still a lot of time to play, but to get back
43 minutes and 18 seconds.
To get back in this game, they've got to get the puck out of their end.
And Gray and Bram in the faceoff circle, won by we'll give that one to Bram, I guess. And Campbell with it now down low in the close corner here for Bram. Bram dropping it back down for Cunningham. Cunningham down to Campbell, tripped up on her own skates. And Bram and Burns and Keefe with it for the Blades, trying to get it up and out, and does so as a loose puck at the Blades blue line there. Down the left side of the rink from our vantage point here. End-to-end action to Joan Snyder. And Bailey Bram with it for the Inferno, trying to get it out in front on her knees, just losing it. And Lacasse pushing it away with her stick as Tremblay with it now. Down the left wing, making a move around Aoki, over to the forehand, shot wide, and follows her own rebound over to the corner. Can't get the shot off now. As here comes number 22, Wickenheiser, rink wide, over to Campbell. Campbell shot off the glove of Lacasse and up over the net. Almost another one there for Jess Campbell. As the Inferno applying lots of pressure here all the way through the period. Wickenheiser with it now. And bringing in down Hag. Hag broken up by DeMasi. And DeMasi managing to get it up and out. No icing on this one. Pieri in pursuit of it there as Myers on top of her. Circling it around the boards. Held in at the blue line by the Blades. But picked up by the Inferno. And unable to clear it out as Myers makes a move at the blue line. And Inferno breaking that one up back for Watchorn as Peg in deep on the forecheck. Watchorn behind her own net. And passing it off to the right. Murphy stepping up is Jenner. Jenner's pass back to Sonia on the one time, but a great save by Lacasse as Inferno still applying the pressure here. Lovell, Jenner down low, trying to get it behind. Watchorn picks it up, push it into the corner. Webster keeping it down low. Esposito on the puck as DeMasi trying to get her. And the shot by Lovell doesn't make it through as St. Germain gets it up and out. And we got a penalty coming here to the Boston Blades with 57.3 left in the first period.
And Tara Watchorn going off for hooking there. These are no beer leaguers that you're playing against tonight. They are good hockey players, and they are putting the pressure on, and Calgary is continuing to do so, frustrating the Boston Blades. And that penalty there, not really around the puck there, not really taking away a scoring chance. Boston Blades coach is not going to be very happy about that one.
And this faceoff to the right, Jean-Vivien Lacasse, won by the Inferno, back to the point as Cudmore with it now, pushing down low to Sonia. Back up for Cudmore and over to Esposito. Esposito on the back end, dropping it into Jenner. Jenner with it now. Back over to Cudmore, one-time shot through the screen. Esposito and Lacasse with an amazing pad save there. Esposito with it, trying to make the move out front. Burns knocking that one away. Jenner with it now. Up high, Sonia. Over to Cudmore. Cudmore slap pass, trying to find Turnbull. And just wide of her is Burns against Sonia in the low corner here. In there is Turnbull battling for it as well. And it's picked up by Esposito for the Inferno. Down to Turnbull on the backhand shot high. Saved by Lacasse. And she hangs on to that. We got 12.3 seconds left to play. A minute 15 in the Inferno power play.
So some very nice pressure again by the Calgary Inferno. If they can't put one past Lacasse here in 12.3 seconds, they'll still have a minute 12, a minute 13, depending on how the
Let's do
clock
a minute
ticks.
Three. A minute three.
Oh, yeah.
I thought you were good at math.
I was going the other way around.
There we go. All right. And back
been a long
is
day.
Pierre at the Blades blue line. Down to Wickenheiser, back to Pierre. Pierre's shot doesn't make it through there. DeMasi with it now in the corner. That's going to do it for first period action here at the Joan Snyder Arena. We are sitting with the Calgary Inferno up by a score of 4-0 on 18 shots and 4 shots for the Boston Blades.
That's correct. And when we are back from this short commercial break, we'll be back with our good friend Sean Ritchie. He'll be down there with the first goal scorer of the game, number 27, Jill Sonnier.
100% énergie. 100% passion. 100% effort. Pourtant, les femmes n'ont que 5% de visibilité. Les producteurs laitiers canadiens croient que les athlètes féminines devraient être vues et entendues haut et fort.
I guess I did play the French one.
Oui, oui.
Oui, oui. There's no, nothing wrong with that. We're a bilingual country.
Les Canadiens are not here yet. As I see number 27, Sonia, busy walking over for the interview.
All right, well, let's play the English one then.
100% drive.
They're probably going to end up.
100% passion. 100% effort. But women in sports get only 5% of the attention. Canada's dairy farmers believe women in sports should be seen and heard loud and clear.
And we'll keep you occupied as they get set up down in the interview area there. Marshall, a very dominant performance by the Calgary Inferno to start that period there. And they held on to it and they applied that pressure all the period, the whole period through.
End-to-end action, and there, it looks as though
there's Sean Ritchie ready with Jill Sonnier. We'll send it down to you, Sean.
Thanks, Marshall and Jeff, standing here with Jill Sonnier, who started off the offensive output for the Calgary Inferno here in the first period. Big 4 goals for you guys. How important was it to come out of the gate this hot and not let your foot off the gas pedal, so to speak?
Yeah, huge. Obviously, you know, it's the first game of the season. All the other girls have already played a game, so it was huge for us to come out, you know, had a few practices under our belt, and I'm really proud of the girls for getting on top of things right away.
Obviously, you know, Boston's a very dangerous team. They split their seasons or their series last weekend with the Toronto Furies 1-1. What do you expect to see from the Blades in this second period?
Yeah, they're a great team, very, very deep. You know, they have a great goaltender who's really hard to get by, so they're going to be relentless, so we definitely can't keep our foot off the pedal for sure.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Jill, and best of luck in the last two periods.
Thanks a lot. Thanks for having me.
Jeff Marshall, sending it back up to you.
Awesome. Thanks so much, Sean. You did great for your rookie interview, too.
Oh, thanks, guys.
Yeah, good debut there. And really quickly, one more commercial break, then you can come back to us here.
When I was 7, I wore these gloves. They held this stick. Well, these skates carried me over the blue line.
We won the championship. And now, it's all yours.
Cool. Oh.
And this mouth guard.
I'll get my own. Thanks. The fifth seat.
And we're back here. As you can see, us on camera for this this season there.
Hi, Mom.
I don't know if that's the
Mom's not
best
tuning
thing
in
for you, but no, definitely not. So as we were saying just before we got Sean on there, what does Boston have to do to stifle this Inferno offense early on?
Well, number one, they got to start putting pucks on Delaney Bryan. I mean, all the action has been down in this end. The ice surface has been tilted. Again, we're end-to-end action here at the Jones Snyder Rink. So
I guess for selfish reasons, we're hoping Boston pours it on so it's easier for us to call.
Well, that would be the only reason. I mean, I know that as broadcasters, we're supposed to be impartial, but we make no qualms about being Inferno fans as well. And we've done that coming into our third season now. Absolutely, that's what we're here. We want to give you a quality, unbiased game. But, yeah, we're Inferno fans first, so we make sure that that's the case. But, again, you look at the shots in the first period there. 18 shots for the Inferno to just 4 shots for the Blades. I mean, the Inferno have scored as many goals as the Blades have had shots.
Correct. And, of course, 2 power plays hasn't led to a goal yet on there, but they haven't needed it to. It has helped them generate that pressure and get them a momentum, which has led to goals after the power play. So some nice work by the Inferno early on. Coach Reed's got to be very happy, and you got to think about this. Rebecca Johnson is not in the lineup tonight. How scary does that make you feel?
that actually scares me quite a bit because, of course, you know, league-leading scorer last season. A few players not in the lineup tonight that would definitely make an impact, right? But definitely none more in recent, at least, than Rebecca Johnson there. So hopefully we'll get to see her probably not tomorrow from my understanding, but probably in a couple weeks' time when the Inferno are back here again. Of course, we're back here tomorrow. I know it's only first intermission. We got all night to get through this show. We're back here tomorrow morning.
Bright and early.
Bright and early for an 8 a.m. Mountain Time
get
puck drop. That's only 10 a.m. Eastern, so you should definitely tune in. That one we're not going to be doing the video with, but we are going to be broadcasting as we do with every single Calgary Inferno home game. You're going to be able to check that out at CWHLlive.com/listen. No charge for that one, of course. If you're tuned in now on the simulcast, with the video, you're able to see what we look like probably the first time ever.
Well, I think we got the little shots where I covered your face the last year.
Yeah, they were shooting shot from distance. Way, way down there.
We look better on there.
We got this camera
right,
right
in
here.
Our face.
Right here, yeah. So
the delay is kind of creepy, too.
On the video monitor, yeah. All right, so again, the Blades have to get the shots on Bryan. They need to get some traffic in front of Delaney Bryan. If you don't get any traffic in front of her, you're never going to beat her. She'll stop everything she can see all day long. When you look at what they're doing for Lacasse, they're putting traffic in front. They know that she's a quick left-to-right goaltender.
They're not beating her on straight
shots. And
they're
going the opposite side.
They're not beating her on straight shots.
No.
On the ones she can see and the ones she can set for, they're not beating her on. It's the side-to-side where they're getting past that range, where they're getting the goalie moving the wrong way there as that one-timer by Sonia there,
yep,
where she went the far corner there. So they're doing the things they have to do to score goals on her, things that they didn't do in the Clarkson Cup final last year when they were playing the then Montreal Stars, now Les Canadiens, the Montreal. But Labonte was a wall there. So this is a good sign for a team that needs to have confidence going into the season with the ability to score on any goal in this league, because when you get shut out in your first 2 games and your only 2 games of a Clarkson Cup playoff when you're a favored team, we've seen what that can do in the NHL to teams like the San Jose Sharks, the Toronto Maple Leafs, the Calgary Flames.
I thought you were going to pull the Boston, or sorry, the baseball Toronto Blue Jays, too.
No, and I'd even throw the Winnipeg Jets in there, too. They played, haven't won a game in the playoffs yet.
As the new Jets.
Neither have the Calgary Inferno. So
this is true, yeah.
This is something to remember, is that this team, this franchise, as good as they look on paper, we don't play the game on paper. We play it out there on the ice. And that's why you don't play.
If we played the game on paper, I could actually play.
Yes, that's why
you don't play. I might actually win.
And speaking of playing off on paper or off the ice, something that did happen this summer that the Inferno were heavily involved in was that Clarkson Cup, the Prairie Toyota Clarkson Cup Tour. So let's take a short look at a video showing just what happened this summer with Megan Mickelson, of course, of the Calgary Inferno, and Natalie Spooner of the Toronto Furies, and a few other Inferno players as well.
The Prairie Toyota Clarkson Cup Tour made a stop in the friendly city on Thursday afternoon to one of their biggest turnouts yet. The 8-week tour is spanning 26 stops over the course of the summer and is bringing the Canadian Women's Hockey League Championship trophy across the prairies, along with Olympic gold medalists Natalie Spooner and Megan Mickelson. In tow, they've also brought a 26-by-20-foot synthetic ice surface that allows kids to strap on their skates outside in the middle of the summer. Hundreds of fans stopped by the event here in Moose Jaw throughout the afternoon to meet the Canadian national team members and get their picture with the Clarkson Cup, as well as hit the ice. Mickelson says it's been fun heading to different communities across the prairies and bringing awareness to women's hockey.
So far it's been an amazing turnout. I'm from Regina, I was born there, so I always love coming back to this part of Saskatchewan, but it's been a great turnout so far. I think speaks to the Minor Hockey Association and the town, obviously a pretty good hockey town.
To start off the event, six lucky local female hockey players were able to hit the ice with Mickelson and Spooner for some drills and instruction. Talia Kane says it was pretty exciting to share the ice with some of her hockey heroes.
It was nice just to learn some new drills and be out there with them.
The hope is to inspire the young hockey players to follow their dreams, much like Spooner and Mickelson were encouraged to do when they were first starting out in the sport.
I mean, I think I was pretty fortunate being able to look up to a lot of female hockey players also. I remember probably I was like 10 or 11 going to a camp and Jennifer Botterill was there and she had her medals and I thought it was the coolest thing ever getting to meet her and go on the ice with her. So I kind of just think about that and what it's like for these kids, because I think that was kind of the moment where it sparked, you know, my goals of being wanting to be like her and play in the Olympics and play on Team Canada.
The goal is to raise the profile of the Canadian Women's Hockey League, which has been growing over the past few years. The CWHL is a professional women's hockey league with five teams spread out in Boston, Brampton, Calgary, Montreal, and Toronto. Mickelson, who plays for the Calgary Inferno, said the league is building momentum and they would love to see it continue to grow and give women's hockey players somewhere to show their skills outside of every 4 years at the Olympics.
It's taken some time to kind of build itself up, but anything, I think a league like this, it has to be built on a solid foundation. So that's what they've done. And it's definitely, the buzz is definitely spreading, I think, across Canada. So that's why we're doing this tour, is to get the Clarkson Cup out there, to get UHL out there, get the name out there.
The Clarkson Cup Tour will continue to travel through BC, Alberta, Saskatchewan, and Manitoba until the middle of August. For DiscoverMooseJaw.com, I'm Mark Smith.
So, of course, that was the Toyota Clarkson Cup Tour, the Prairie Toyota Clarkson Cup Tour that happened this summer, and had a chance to make it out to a couple of those events. It was a great time. A lot of kids there, a lot of new faces to the Calgary Inferno. And as we see here in the crowd, it definitely has had a positive effect for us with the attendance, as well as growing the game as well and getting the Clarkson Cup out there and showing off for that. Ain't that right, Marshall?
Yeah.
Boy, if you're this talkative in our post-game show, we got a better hope that we get some real talkers up here.
I'll be fine for the post-game show, of course. That one, new sponsor we'd like to welcome as well for the post-game show, brought to you by Boston Pizza Motel Village.
Missed it. Yes, I'm no Vanna White, clearly.
I saw the end of it there, yes.
I'll try it again here. Here we go.
The Boston Pizza Motel Village post-game show. Say that 27 times fast. And you too can have the same number as Jill Sonier.
Now, for those fans in attendance today, what do they get when they go down there after the game?
Well, this is the other thing. Any Inferno fan who is in attendance, all you got to do is take your ticket stub from game day, and you'll get 10% off your order at Boston Pizza. Of course, some restrictions may apply. and they'll have all the details there at the restaurant for you. That's at the Boston Pizza Motel Village, which is just conveniently located about 5 minutes away from Joan Snyder Winsport here on 16th Avenue. So go check that out afterwards.
Excellent. While we're on the topic of people we couldn't do this without, let's thank our sponsors once again there. So CWHL and the Calgary Inferno would like to express our thanks to our sponsors, the Canada's Dairy Farmers, Scotiabank, Sportsnet, Winsport, Bauer, Tim Hortons, Toyota, Molson Coors, the Globe and Mail, Bridgeforce, Porter, Gong Show Gear, OMGs, the Calgary Flames, the Toronto Maple Leafs, the Montreal Canadiens, the Calgary Old Time Hockey Players Association, Alberta Athletic Therapists Association, Deckel Doctors, and Sockbox.ca. Hey, are you wearing your Sockbox socks? You can show them off right now. We're on camera.
No, it's too low. Let's see. I have my.
Oh, look at that.
Yeah, I have my Inferno ones on.
It's InfernoSockbox.ca socks there. Only available in Canada. Story to our Boston Blades listeners. We don't want to rub it in, but some of the best things are only available in Canada.
Like us?
I was saying like your socks, but.
Oh, yes, yes. That works too.
You know, I finally give you a compliment. I think you'd actually know how to. You wouldn't know how to.
I'm
take
not.
It
I'm
you're
not
used
to it at all. I have no clue what you're talking about as far as a compliment is concerned from you. We got about 2 minutes remaining here.
As the refs come back onto the ice, it's still not too late to get your tickets for tomorrow's game. If you're listening at home, you've seen the action here. You know what's going on. CalgaryInferno.ca/tickets. Or just come on down here to Winsport in the Joan Snyder Arena. Get here early as seating is limited, but lots of great seats available for you.
And wow, I'm looking at our listeners here.
They're all in the States, aren't they? And I'm in trouble now.
we have a number of listeners tuned in, of course, in the United States, and of course across Canada. And konnichiwa to those of you tuned in Japan. No doubt, in my mind, two of the national Japanese players applying an impact there. One returning from last year in Aina Takeuchi. And of course, the rookie as well coming through from Japan. Kanai Aoki.
Aoki,
yes.
I'm looking forward to the time she scores a goal so I can be like, Aoki!
She told me it was Aoki, though.
Well, then I go, Aoki!
There we go. Perfect. Sounds good. All right. We are under a minute away from second period action here at the Joan Snyder Arena at Winsport, where the Calgary Inferno are leading the visiting Boston Blades by a score of 4-0 on goals that period, coming from Sonia Lovell, Campbell and Jenner in that order as we're going to call that three rookie goals, even though Jenner really wasn't the rookie goal. So she did have to come in through the draft this year.
She came into the draft because she was out of the league and not on an active roster or claimed roster, but she is definitely not a rookie to the CWHL, having played a couple years as a teen before she went off to Cornell.
Right,
and
yep.
And starred in Big Red.
And she played with Mississauga as well as Burlington. Both those teams now no longer exist in the league. Back in the 08-09 season as well as the 09-10 season, playing 43 games, including through the Clarkson Cup playoffs there, netting 20 goals over those two seasons. Of course, 11 goals in that last season. So no stranger to the score sheet either.
No, definitely not. There's a reason why she's wearing the C, and it's not just because it comes after B.
Yes, thanks. Jeez. And
sometimes you get stuck, you just got to go.
There we go. We got 1:03 left in the power play for the Calgary Inferno. Of course, the penalized player, Tara Watchhorn, captain for the Boston Blades, former Inferno member as well. As end-to-end action here now in the second period, Delaney Bryan right in front of us. And at the opposite end of the rink there, Genevieve Lacasse, as Wickenheiser wins that for the Inferno. Pieri back at her own blue line, left wing over for Bram, skates up over the line. Backhand pass
down and broken up by Boston as puck dumped in and Brian plays it behind her net there around the boards. As we got a stoppage of play here with just 20 seconds gone in the second period.
And if you're the Boston Blades, you got to like the start of that penalty kill there, getting the puck down deep, getting a whistle down in Calgary's zone and killing off the first 20 seconds of this second period here.
All right, we're going to get a trying to figure out faceoff coming here to the left of Delaney Bryan in the Inferno zone. As Brown winning that one, but pushing it back now. Cudmore with it for the Inferno, battling with Brown along the boards. Jenner with it now, trying to clear it up and out. Held in at the blue line by number 7, Burns, pushing it around the boards all the way. Over on the right side was Myers. Sorry, St. Germain hanging on to that one. Level with it now, trying to clear it up and out. Down the right wing is Jenner. Jenner centering pass over to Cudmore. Shot wide to the right of Lacasse. As we got 10 seconds left in the Inferno power play. Battling down to the opposite end of the rink. Along the boards, Lovell keeping it in for the Inferno. Rink wide by the Blades. And dumping it in. And Delaney Bryan gloving it for a stoppage of play just as the penalty to Tara Watchhorn comes to an end with 18:54 left in the second period here.
Oh, and talk about getting your hockey legs back. We totally missed the fact that Calgary got a penalty back there. As our favorite friend, Jackie, the penalty box, Pierre, is back in the penalty box.
Yes, you're right. I do see only 4 Inferno on the ISO. The first penalty kill for the Inferno as Watchhorn with a shot from the high slot at the blue line there, wide of Brian Murphy with it now. Shot low. Loose puck squeaks through, unable to connect on that was Brown. As Murphy with it for the Blades now. Drops it off for Myers, back up to the blue line. Murphy puts a shot wide. Brown and Davis. Davis gets it up, and Watchhorn unable to get the hip over on the boards as it squeaks through down the length of the ice there with just 35 seconds left in the penalty kill for the Inferno. As coming down is Boston. Knocked off her puck now is Cunningham. In the Inferno zone, loose puck down in front. Campbell forward backhand and ran out of room as Lacasse stood strong there. Campbell with it now. Pushing it around opposite end as Boston clears it up and out. And Boston got an icing call there against Boston.
I forgot to tell my funny story about Genevieve Lacasse on Twitter. She, of course, saw the photo that we used to promote the upcoming game, which was a photo of her looking like it was being scored on by Jessica Campbell, to which she replied, "I remember my first goal." The funny thing about that, of course, was that was actually a save. It was in the shootout at our youth mental health game at the end of the season last year over in Rink A of Winsport.
And Wickenheiser with the win for the Inferno. Aoki dropping it in down behind the Blades net, battling for it. Now as the penalized players out of the box up the blue line. As both teams full strength now, 17:30 left. Loose puck down in front. Wickenheiser gets the shot away. Lacasse standing strong on that. Wickenheiser with it now at the faceoff circle, trying to center it out in front. And held in by Takeuchi at the blue line as it's over. Sonia dropped Wickenheiser rink wide over Takeuchi. Up front, Sonia shot through traffic and wide of the net as the Inferno battling for it down low up to the blue line at the point. Takeuchi rink wide. Aoki shot, pad save by Lacasse as the Blades looking to make a move out and picked off at center ice there. Aoki over for Hag. And Watchhorn now back for the Blades behind her net off the right wing boards. Nice bounce there as Brian pushing it down in the corner there. Webster with it for the Inferno now. Up to the left for Kirio. Kirio trying to bring it in down the left wing. Kirio drops it for Davis, who had skated out off the boards. Circles back for it, grabs it as that's pushed down and in. And back out in the neutral zone now. As action at the opposite end of the rink here with 16:10 left in the second period. Davis with the puck. Puck loose out front, and no Inferno player home, as breaking in down the left wing now is number five, St. Germain, trying to fend off Cudmore. St. Germain with it still, close side, left up to the point. Watchhorn, rink wide, and unable to get it through was Tremblay. Davis battling for it now in the corner. Turnbull up and out of her zone, center ice there is Kirio with it. And Watchhorn unable to keep that one in as she retreats back into her own end. And the Inferno off on a line change. Watchhorn with it. Skates over her blue line. And knocked off her stick. St. Germain back with it now. Lifting it up and out and into the Calgary Inferno bench as we got 15:24 left to play in the second period.
Well, with that, I'd like to remind you, since our videos aren't working, that you can follow us on Twitter at InfernoCWHL for all in-game updates and news and breaking news. Ain't that right, Marcel?
Ain't that right?
Ain't that right?
That right.
Not as nice as when the nice, very skilled and very talented players do it.
Even more so, definitely. As we got 15:24 left to play here, and the faceoff coming to the left of Geneviève Lacasse. And we look at shots this period, 3 for Boston to 4 for the Infernos. The Inferno win it back to the point. Pieri, pass rink wide back to Pieri. Shot and unable to get it through traffic there as Esposito back to Pieri trying to get the shot off. Looking to notch another goal on the Infernos 4-0 lead right now with 15 minutes in the second left to play. The Inferno applying pressure from at the point. Pushing it in and down. Rink wide over to Pieri. Pieri shot in the middle and looking for a redirect. Couldn't get that there. As now breaking up down the right wing is Keefe. As Keefe hangs onto it, Pieri all over her, knocks her off. Jenner with it now. Jenner trying to gate out of the Inferno zone. Does so. Level with it now at center ice. Coming in down, makes a move around the Boston player, but can't get on that as Duncan was there taking away that lane and unable to get it to center, to the center for a scoring chance.
Just out there in the center, eh?
Just out there in the center. As action opposite end there, as Campbell trying to skate out from the corner and just fanning on that as she skated through Lacasse's crease. As it's sent wide by Takeuchi, and that's up. And I think that went up and over the glass.
Well, as they get another puck, we want to thank some of our sponsors again. The Canada's Dairy Farmers, Scotiabank, Sportsnet, Winsport, Bauer, Tim Hortons, Toyota, Molson Coors, The Globe and Mail, Bridge Force, Porter, Gongshou Gear, and OMGs.
And his faceoff coming to the right of the Cavs, won by the Blades. As Boston trying to clear their end and unable to do so as the Inferno keeping that in is Bram with it now. Bram for the Inferno at the high right point. Up to the slot, hanging it, shot off the blocker of Lacasse as Bram finds her own rebound again as down for Cudmore. Check that Cunningham. Opposite end of the rink here. 14:24, it's hard to see the four. I mean the one or the two. I can't even talk right now, Jeff.
Well, here comes Cunningham there.
Cunningham was looking for the centering pass, couldn't quite sneak it through as on the doorstep there was Bailey Bram and Lacasse covering that up with 13:20 left to play.
Yeah, good move by Cunningham to get to the net there. And with that, we'll thank some of our other sponsors, the Calgary Flames, the Toronto Maple Leafs, the Montreal Canadiens, the Calgary Old Time Hockey Players Association, Alberta Athletic Therapists Association, Deckle Doctors, and Sockbox.ca.
And his faceoff coming to the left of Lacasse, won by the Inferno, back up to the point there. Campbell with a shot. Brew couldn't make it, was Cudmore as battling down on the opposite boards. Watchhorn and Hag battling as time ticking away. And up to the point now as Webster for the Inferno holding it in and knocking it back down low. Loose puck out front, bouncing. And it looks as though Lacasse sprawling and keeping that one out to keep it 4-0 in favor of the Inferno
shots for the game now, 26-7 in favor of the Calgary Inferno.
Yeah, definitely getting a little lopsided on that shot total, but Boston's hanging in there. They haven't given up a goal this period, so that's what you want to see from Boston if you're a Boston fan.
As faceoff won by the Inferno, and a nice, quick, easy shot there by Jill Sagne, who led the scoring off for the Inferno, and a nice save by Lacasse.
Could be a trivia answer question there. Who scored the first goal for the Calgary Inferno in the 2015-16 season? There's your answer right there. Number 27, Jill Sagne.
Rookie.
Jill Sagne.
And this faceoff coming blocker side of Lacasse, opposite end of the rink, as Wickenheiser wins that easily. Back to Cudmore, couldn't get it through off some skates. And it's down into the corner there as Wickenheiser with it now. Trying to get up along the boards and knocked off her stick as Hag with it for the Inferno. Pushing it down and up around the boards there as Boston manages to clear it up and out. And coming down over the Inferno blue line, and the shot from Tremblay, blocker saved by Brian. That's going to put the fourth shot of the period up for the Blades. It's still 4-0 Inferno, 12-10 left in the second period as Shea with it now. Back up to the point for the Blades, and a hot pass over for Tremblay. Manages to catch it down on the low right corner there. Sagne battling with her. Sagne just using her muscling her off the puck as Cudmore up to Wickenheiser. Gets the blue line, drops it there for Sagne. Sagne centering pass wide, and just missing on that conversion was Curio for her first of the season. As Boston gets it up and out to center ice, Crom over to Pieri, mishandling that one, is almost picked up by Kickham. Bringing it down, Davis now. Davis down low, centering pass out front. Couldn't connect on that. Davis still with the puck, back up to the point, Pieri. Pieri shot, bouncing puck off the leg of Keefe. As the Inferno applying more pressure. And Campbell, Turnbull with it. Shot, loose puck down low. Curio trying to bang in the rebound. Lacasse hanging on to that, kicking it out to the corner. Now Davis with it again behind the Boston net. Out front, loose puck shot. On the close side there, Lacasse is going to hang on to that one for that stoppage of play.
And Lacasse once again standing on her head back there, stopping everything that she can to keep her team in this. Boston has to be fortunate that they have her in the net tonight.
As this faceoff coming to the right of Lacasse, as all the players had lined up to the left, but Lacasse knew where it was going. She was over there.
It kind of looked like the Indianapolis Colts trick play.
And now that's football. And Crom with it at the blue line, keeping it in at the point, down in the far corner. End-to-end action here at Jones-Snyder Arena. As Pieri up on the right point, pushing it down low there for number 19, Jenner. Couldn't hang on to it. It's knocked up and out as Crom is on it. Brian out to play it harmlessly off to the left side as Crom was heavily pursued by Kickham. Neutral ice, Jenner with it now over the center ice. Face-off circle, breaking in, trying to come down. Knocked off her stick. As a rink wide over for Takauchi on the high left point. Just pushing that down low for Esposito. Esposito is knocked off her stick here as Boston just unable to get out with 10 minutes left in the second period here. Still 4-0 Calgary Inferno. As Bram makes a move, trying to get around Watchorn and unable to do so. Watchorn with the puck, knocking it off the boards through Takauchi. And bringing it in here is Burns. Burns just puts it on net. Brian with the stick, knocking it loose. Nobody coming down to pot that rebound. Held in at the blue line by Boston. Shot doesn't make it through. As Cunningham now skating down the right wing into the Boston zone. 3-on-2 here. Putting it right past Campbell there. And unable to convert on any shot on that. Webster with it now. And we got a penalty coming up here to the Calgary Inferno, as it looked as though a little bit of incidental contact there between Jenna Cunningham and I believe that was Grace Murphy taking the brunt of that. We're going to get the second penalty kill for the Calgary Inferno here with 9:25 left in the second period.
So let's have some fun with that. Who took that penalty? It was
Jenna Cunningham, forward for Medicine Hat.
Yes,
there it was.
That one played fine.
That one played fine.
Good. Good on you. All right, 9:25 left. 2-minute power play for the Calgary Inferno. This one coming to the right of Delaney Bryan, as it's Christina Brown and Haley Wickenheiser in a face-off dot. 5-on-4 action at Joan Snyder here as Brown's out, kick comes in. And Sonia skates away with that, trying to get it up and out as the Blades with it now in neutralized territory. Dumping it in, down, and we got an icing call against the Boston Blades. You asked about things earlier about Boston, things that they can do. That's one of the things they cannot do.
Yeah, you don't want to ice the puck on the power play there. Take those extra couple strides, get over the red line, then get it in deep, go check, and go get it. And be aggressive on that forecheck. Put pressure on these Calgary D. They've had an easy time of it so far in this game, getting time to pick their spots.
And this faceoff to the right, won by the Inferno. Webster from the point, just pushing that through with 20 seconds gone in the penalty to Cunningham, as Boston trying to get something, anything going, as they're being heavily outshot 12-5 in the second period. As Watchhorn looks back and forth, tries to find someone, and Webster swinging their stick, manages to knock that.
That's a long stick.
Yeah, gets it around the boards at 6 foot. You got to have a long stick for that. Breaking in down the right wing, trying to make a move to the front of the net, taken down. Still managing to get the shot off there is Jill Sonnier for the Inferno, but the Blades now looking to make a move, coming back as we're halfway through that penalty kill. Kick him over to Burns. Burns along the close half board, up to kick him. Just dumping it down low into the corner here. Myers trying to get it around the boards. Nobody at the opposite point there. Little confusion. Turnbull trying to break down the right wing. Watchhorn picks it up at her own blue line. Rink wide off the boards. And icing waved off as both Myers and Crom going nicely into the boards. Up to the point there. A long shot as Turnbull knocks that off the stick. And Boston back up to the point there for Tremblay. Tremblay trying to get the shot through. A rebound, and Murphy, had she been able to connect, had an open net to get Boston on the board. Boston managing to keep it in there as Murphy tries to get around a sprawling Crom. Pieri picking it up off the glass, out at the blue line, held in by Tremblay. Tremblay now, as we've got 5 seconds left. Shot through, rebound, save. Bryan and Boston unable to convert as Davis up to Cunningham, and Cunningham couldn't hang on to that one now as Burns with it back. The Blades now, Davis down the left wing, shot, Lacasse, rebound. We got ourselves another goal for the Calgary Inferno. Not sure who that one went in off, but that's gonna make it 5-0 for the Calgary Inferno with 7:10 left.
Does look like Jenna Cunningham is getting the celebrations for that, coming out of the box, getting involved with the play. As we take a look at it here, shot and the rebound, Cunningham pots that and does the Bobby Orr dive over Genevieve Lacasse. So since we played it for getting the penalty, we might as well play it again here. Goal scored by
Jenna Cunningham, forward for Medicine Hat.
There you go.
All right, that's gonna make it 5-0 for the Inferno here in front of a sold out crowd at the Joan Snyder Arena. As Takeuchi with it for the Inferno, up over center ice there, pass, Bram down the right wing. And Cunningham from Davis, just after that penalty had expired to Cunningham, as Aoki with it, putting it on net, and Lacasse hanging on for a stoppage of play here with 6:42 left in the second period. 5-0.
It is 5-0. It's a good start for the Calgary Inferno. You know that they wanted to come out blazing in front of this sold-out home crowd here tonight. They wanted to put on a show. They wanted to show that all these fans that are out here buying the Inferno merchandise from our brand new store at calgaryinferno.ca/shop, that they chose the right team to support.
And face-off to the left of Lacasse, and the Inferno with it now, trying to center it on ice, keep adding to that score as it's now out at center ice. Cudmore with it now, circling back, trying to get it in. There's Esposito down the right side, drops it off there for Jenner and couldn't get the shot through. As action now at the blue line there, Cudmore hanging on to it and pushing it in down low. Jenner with it now, trying to get it out front. Lacasse staying low, taking away that bottom area. Esposito pushing it behind the net. Jenner trying to step out, can't get any action on that. Jenner with it now, far left corner, trying to get it over to Esposito. Couldn't do so, broken up by the Blades as it's now at center ice there. Jenner hangs on, circles back, dumping it in off on a line change. As we got 5:50 left in the second period here. If you're tuning in on CWHLLive.com and the simulcast as well at CWHLLive.com/listen on our audio-only version. It's the Calgary Inferno leading the Boston Blades 5-0 and with about 5:30 left in the second period here. Lacasse, actually, when you do the math on that, only letting in 5 on 34 shots is it's still impressive.
A full 60 minutes, Nate. Full 60 minutes of work, normally.
Normally.
And of course, with that, the CWHL Live is presented by the Canada's Dairy Farmers Fueling Women's Champions Program. With women's sport making up less than 5% of sports media coverage and women's sport getting around 0.4% of all sports sponsorship money, Fueling Women's Champion is dedicated to turning around these statistics by directly tackling challenges that women and girls face pursuing sports through their partnership and organization like the CWHL.
And we're back underway here. Shot from the high slot there by Pierre. He doesn't make it all the way through as the Blades trying to clear it up and out, and they do so. Pierre back at her own blue line, though. Stood up by Myers there. If there was hitting, man, that would have been a great one. As Murphy with it now, down to Myers. Myers trying to make something happen for the Blades here. And Myers with it behind the Inferno net now. Hag with it, trying to get up around the left wing there. Does so, getting that pass Duncan. As it's back in the Blade zone at the opposite end of the rink there. As Murphy bringing it down, knocked off her stick by Hag. And Wickenheiser with it. Wickenheiser at the top. Shot right on the chest of Geneviève Lacasse, who hangs on to that one for another stoppage of play here with 4:28 left in the second period.
And if there's one theme that continues to be the trend, if you shoot on the cast straight up, she's going to stop you. If you get her with the rebound, if you get her moving side to side, that's when the Inferno have won. All five goals have come off either a rebound or a cross-ice pass that's gone as a one-timer.
And face-off won by the Inferno as it's dumped the length of the ice here. And Aoki with it, skating up the right wing. Rink-wide pass over for Kirio. She gains the Boston zone. Kirio with it now. Will flip pass over top there, looking for Sarah Davis, unable to connect on that. As Turnbull with it over for Davis, dropped down low, trying to make a move. Was Kirio, couldn't get it through. Held into the blue line by Davis. Over to Kirio on the shot there, and Lacasse hanging onto that. It was actually over to Turnbull, who passed it back to Kirio and got a good shot. Lots of tape-to-tape action here for the Calgary Inferno this evening.
And speaking of action, there is some action going on out east in Brampton as the Toronto Furies and Brampton Thunder are headed to overtime, tied 1-1 after three periods there.
And we'll keep you posted on that one as well as best as we can. As Davis waved out, Turnbull in for the faceoff for the Inferno 1, but then knocked the length of the ice by the Blades player. And we're gonna do this one over for you once again to the left of Lacasse. It's gonna be her glove side.
And speaking to the left of us downstairs there, we have our hockey, Calgary minor hockey team ready for the mini game during the first intermission here out on the ice. Looks like a lot of very excited girls ready to play some hockey in front of this sold out crowd.
And the Inferno applying the pressure there as Kirio fans on the puck. And Boston trying to get it up and out, does so, as through center ice is number 21, Olivia Keefe. Couldn't hang on to that though. Webster with it now, back behind, trying to get it out off Gray's leg. And Webster circles back for it, over to Cudmore. Cudmore trying to get it out and does so off Tremblay's stick. Davis in pursuit. Davis knocking that around, in on a partial break and goes wide to the right of Lacasse. As Boston now bringing it in down as Tremblay with it. Held up by Pierre. Can't make anything happen there. Cunningham with it for the Inferno behind her on net, skating up the right wing over to Bram. Bram trying to make a move through neutral ice, knocked off by Murphy. Over on the left side now, Crom with it. Crom centering pass, rink wide over for Campbell, who's going to pot that one in for her second of the night to make it 6-0 for the Calgary Inferno here with 2:46 left in the second period.
Nice job by both Bram and Cunningham to get back onside there, allowing Crom to come up the left side boards and find Jessica Campbell on another cross-ice pass that finds the back of the net behind Genevieve Lacasse, who, despite giving up 6 goals, still has 31 saves on the night and is playing one heck of a hockey game.
And face-off at center ice, won by the Blades, as Murphy with it, dumping it in around the corner. Bryan back to play it. Pierre with it now. Up, gives that one away. Shot just stepping in, unable to do so. Boston trying to center that in the slot area. Myers with it now for the Blades on the backhand and knocked wide by Bram as Campbell with it for the Inferno, trying to get up and out of her zone there. Almost pulled off her stick by Myers there. As back in the Inferno end, and we got an icing call on that one against Boston. A bunch of exhausted players out there who were desperately wanting a line change.
Well, this is a late time for them. It's already about 9:39 out east right now. So like playing at 10 o'clock at night, travel day, you're not gonna be your freshest, but these are pro athletes and they compete.
Well, tomorrow's gonna be fun. We're on air at 7:45, I guess, with a pregame show. Of course, join us today after the game on cdbohllive.com/listen for the Boston Pizza Motel Village postgame show. We'll let you know more about that as the game progresses here, as we got a minute 56 left in the second period at 6-0 for the Calgary Inferno on that last goal, her second of the night, coming from Jessica Campbell.
And don't forget to give us a like over on Facebook to stay up to date on all the news and major updates in the Calgary Inferno.
And we got Jenner and Brown in the faceoff circle to the right of Lacasse, won by Brown as the Blades trying to get something more going here with a minute 45 in the second and unable to clear their zone as they finally do. Coming through center ice there, coming down the right wing, stepping over the blue line, and a shot wide was Kickham. St. Germain in the corner, Jenner with it now, Jenner trying to get something going. Stick knocked out of St. Germain's hand. Jenner with it up to the left wing. Campbell back over to Jenner. Jenner over center ice. Right wing pass over for Esposito. Trying to find Jenner again. A little give and go action. Unable to connect on that. As we are seconds away from the final minute of the second period here. 6-0 Calgary Inferno still. As the Blades clear their zone. Webster with it. At center ice, there's our minute left in the second period. As Jenner tried to dump that in and almost hit the new Inferno trainer, Joe.
Yeah, almost got the equipment manager there. He was quick enough to dodge back on that one. As currently the shots, 38-12, 54.2 left in the second period here.
And this faceoff coming out of the Inferno zone, right out front of the Blades bench. Cudmore with it though. Off the stick of Wickenheiser, didn't realize it was there. And we have our first offside call of the game.
Well, it was Jill Sonnier just a step ahead of Kelsey Webster, who had jumped up on the play after that puck had deflected off Wickenheiser's stick and negates the chance. We'll have a face-up just to the outside of the zone.
And Wickenheiser in there for the Inferno. We're gonna give that win to her there. As it's back to Webster, over to Cudmore. Cudmore up to Sonnier, bringing it in. Sonnier down the right wing, cutting to the middle on that, on the forehand. And Lacasse hanging onto that one with 32.6 seconds left in the second period here.
Well, you know, if you're Boston, you don't want to give up another one with less than a minute to go in the period. It's never a good thing to be scored on with a minute left in the period. Always a demoralizing blow. And Boston would love to keep this tied up or get one of their own to break that shutout of Delaney Bryan.
And face off in the Boston zone to the glove side of Lacasse. Tie it up and the skates back up to the point. Webster's long shot in on that rink wide pass from Cudmore. Couldn't connect it, 20 seconds left. Boston coming down the left wing here. Breaking in, making a move, trying to cut towards the front of the net. And a loose puck out in front. As Webster was taken down into Bryan, Myers managed to get that great shot off, looking for a bit of a redirect and a deflection. 11.1 seconds left here. Bryan still holding that that shutout true, as you mentioned earlier. You would have jinxed it. I just unjinxed it by mentioning it again. So
is that how it works? Well, we tried to jinx Levante in everything we could in the playoffs, and that didn't work. So.
That was last year. This is this year. Let's look forward, not backwards. As the Inferno are up 6-0 here, I can pretty much safely say after two periods of play.
Well, my view forward is hockey. My view backwards is the
we have people standing. We have people standing out there too,
and lining up too, and everything. So.
Yeah. So there we go. End of the second. End of the second period. There, 6-0 is your score for the Calgary Inferno on goals coming from Jenna Cunningham and the second of the night, Jessica Campbell. If you want to talk crazy numbers, look at the shot column there. 21 shots for the Inferno in that period to 10 for the Boston Blades. Now, I will tell you that Boston did turn it on a little bit more. I mean, they more than doubled their shots from the first period.
They definitely
they're gonna need a heck of a lot more to get something else going.
They definitely look better there, and we're gonna take a quick commercial break. Then we'll be back with Sean downstairs.
100% drive. 100% passion. 100% effort. But women in sports get only 5% of the attention. Canada's dairy farmers believe women in sports should be seen and heard loud and clear.
All right, and as we get set back up downstairs, we've got our Hockey Calgary minor league hockey team out on the ice there for a little bit of hockey there. And goaltender Kathy Desjardins, who returns to the Calgary Inferno, is playing net for one of the teams as we're live downstairs with Sean. Go ahead, Sean.
Thanks, Jeff from Marshall. Obviously, the first two periods have not gone the way the Boston Blades have wanted. What do you think the biggest factor here tonight has been in the team's game plan not being executed?
I don't know. I mean, we're playing well out there. We're breaking out. We're getting some good chances on net, so we just got to keep doing what we're doing.
Yeah, the second half of the second period, you guys really turned it on, and you could see you were playing much better than the first half of the even the first period. What changes do you think need to be made offensively to get back into this game as we head into the final 20 minutes?
Yeah, I think just keep crashing the net. We're getting some good rebounds there, so keep crashing the net, and we'll put one in.
Awesome. Well, best of luck to you on the best last 20 minutes of the game. Now we're going to take a look at some of the action that's happened over the first two periods of play here between Calgary and Boston.
All right, so here's going to be a few of our goals early on. Here's the first goal by the Calgary Inferno as we see it setting up and coming across here. Eventually, or is this one of the, no, just some nice saves by Genevieve Lacasse. I got ahead of myself. Maybe we should let the highlights speak for themselves.
Yeah, that only works if you're watching the video at cwhl.live.com.
Well, here's the goal. This is the one there.
Yes. Wickenheiser over to Saunier there for the Inferno's first goal of the 2015-16 season. And Saunier's first.
And speaking of goals, there's one on the ice here on Kathy Desjardins. There was Lovell's first of her career as well.
Very similar to that first goal, if you notice it, the left to right.
Oh, it's all crossing, and anytime it's straight on, Genevieve Lacasse is up to the task there. Obviously, unhappy with the result right now, being down 6-0. You could hear it in her voice, but she's played one heck of a game for the Boston Blades and has done everything she can to make this one a contest.
And Delaney Bryan facing 10 more shots that period than she had in the previous period. If we go at those numbers, that means that Boston should get a whole lot more shots this period as well.
Well, it's very possible. They're in a hole. They got to dig themselves out. And the one way to do that, as any coach will say, is get the puck on the net. Get the puck on the net. Get the puck on the net. Get traffic in front of the net. Cause trouble. And good things will happen. As we see on that shot there, as Jessica Campbell tried to get the puck on net, but went a little bit high over the glove of Lacasse.
Well, when you look at it, Lacasse is sitting there right now in this game with a 8.46 save percentage.
which is still a respectable number.
Especially with the quality of shots that she's had to face tonight. As Kathy Desjardins going for a little skate and gets it stolen and it's going in. I'm calling two things at once here.
Yeah, so if you're tuned in on CWHLLive.com watching the video feed and it doesn't make sense to you,
it's because I'm doing it.
There you go.
Well, that was a very nice goal by Jessica Campbell there on a nice feed by Erica Crom. And there's some of that action out there on the ice as you see Kathy Desjardins having some fun with our Hockey Calgary mini game here.
Of course, Desjardins taking the season off last year and very excited to be back with the Inferno once again this season.
Yes, she was.
Kathy Desjardins, goaltender, Le Red Wings, Quebec.
Kathy Desjardins was very very adamant about trying to make a comeback this year, working very hard in the offseason to get into game shape, to be ready to push for a job with the Inferno. Now we have the same goaltending duo that we had when you and I started with the Calgary Inferno 3 years ago with the late Delaney Bryan and the lady known adamantly as Frenchie.
But let me tell you, there's been a lot of changes over those two seasons, behind the bench, on the ice, in the stands here as well. I mean, you got to look, we're here at intermission, and there's only a handful of empty seats still, I would say.
Absolutely, and while there's been a lot of change, one thing hasn't changed, and that's been some of our sponsors. One that's been with us for a long time is Scotiabank. Let's take you to a little commercial right now.
When I was 7, I wore these gloves. They held this stick. Well, these skates carried me over the blue line.
We won the championship. And now, it's all yours.
Cool. Oh,
and this mouth guard.
I'll get my own. Thanks.
The fifth season.
And the fifth season, hockey season, of course, woo-hoo, is back.
Back in Calgary, back with a vengeance. Flames not doing so great, but hey, you know what?
They had a big win last night. The captain, Giordano, coming through for them in the clutch. A beautiful goal there. Patience that he made himself look like he was the player he was last year, not the one we've seen the first few games from him as well. So a good weekend to be a Calgary hockey fan. You have a win for the Flames. You're 20 minutes away from a win if things stay the way they are here.
You are just jinxing this all over the place tonight, aren't you?
Well, you know what? Sometimes you got to push it a bit.
No, this is Footloose, not push it.
As we take a little selfie. Well, I guess not really a selfie if he's taking the photo, is it?
Yeah, no. Our another addition to our team this year, actually, Joseph.
Yes.
Taking some additional photos around, helping out team photographer Dave Holland, who's been snapping pictures for longer than the time that we've been around.
Yeah, he's been around since the year one, which was 5 years ago. Of course, this is the fifth year that Team Alberta / Calgary Inferno has been in the CWHL. There is only two players on the roster currently who have played in every single season for the Calgary Inferno. That, of course, is the following.
Jenna Cunningham, forward for Medicine Hat.
And not as quick as this I'd like to be.
Kelsey Webster, defense, Duncan, BC.
That is Jenna Cunningham and Kelsey Webster starting off 5 years ago with Team Alberta wearing the dark blue with
gold,
yellow and silver trim on it. They've come a long way with this team, going from a team that struggled heavily to win anything in the first couple seasons to improving a little bit in the third season, getting a bit of wins there, managing to get into the Clarkson Cup playoffs for their first time in existence, to finishing second in the league last year, to now being ranked as arguably the favorite to finish first.
You understand that I'm taking credit for all this, right? Oh, well, I mean that we're taking credit for all this. We got involved broadcasting, and then, you know, they made it to the postseason, and then last year they finished better and made it to the postseason again. See, the issue is...
So what you're saying is that our questions...
Because we're not doing play-by-play and color for it.
So what you're saying is that because of the questions we asked, it caused them to get better by understanding the weaknesses in their games that they had to improve. Is that what you're saying?
Agreed. 100%.
Well, I don't think that is right at all, but hey, it's not the first time we'll agree to disagree.
This is very true. Speaking of, let's have a quick look here. We were talking about Cunningham, of course, who got that fifth goal for the Inferno this evening, her first on the season.
Marshall's looking at his hockey guidebook featuring Angela James Bowl winner Rebecca Johnston from the Calgary Inferno.
And when you look at Cunningham's regular season stats over the last season, she's played in 80 games with 29 goals and 22 assists for a good total of 66. Definitely a force felt on the Inferno. And then I can't tell you anything.
But Jenna Cunningham still is the leading scorer all time for Team Alberta and the Calgary Inferno. And with that, we want to take another quick little break here to watch a former Calgary Inferno who played a nice little prank on some gentlemen over in Boston. And that, of course, was Tara Watchhorn having some fun with some people like me, some out-of-shape beer leaguers.
Hey, she's kind of good.
Yeah.
Is that what they say about you?
No.
Yeah.
No,
she's
not normally.
Good. Of course, that other longtime Inferno player, Kelsey Webster there, if we want to go back and look at all of her stats, CWHL regular season, she's played in 96 games for a total of 2 goals. Those coming back in the 2012-13 season as Alberta and the 13-14 season as the Calgary Inferno. So we can take credit for one of Webster's goals, but not all two of them. And then
you got a whole book of stuff to go through with enough knowledge there. How about we worry about some stats from today since it's working on your computer, it's not working on mine. How are we looking in the face-off department over there?
Face-offs won right now. Again, in favor of the Inferno over the Blades, 27-17 there. If I'm going down all the columns here, let's see here. Inferno are dominating on every opportunity right now. Shots, we know about that. Score, we know about that. Face-offs as well. Looks like we're getting most of the stuff, not quite all of it though, right? You know, chances, takeaways, that kind of stuff. But
how's our player recap page looking there?
I don't know. You tell me. this is your stats mess. Funny.
Well, I can see right now Haley Wickenheiser, 12 of 19 faceoffs won. Not a bad performance through two periods of pay in the faceoff dot for the veteran rookie Haley Wickenheiser. How's that?
It looks like Turnbull sitting at 1 of 4 right now is the worst face-off taker for the Inferno there. And when we go down and look at the Boston Blades here, Giannini is wearing number one
there
tonight.
That tells you there. See, you got all that information there.
You mean
normally number four wearing number one tonight.
No, Giannino.
Yeah.
We got it written down wrong in the stats there. So.
And the teams have returned to the ice here as we finish looking at our computers and turn our attention back to the ice.
Are you sure?
No, I'm probably not. As we've got just a minute here until puck drop. So Marshall, what do you think here? What's the final score gonna be? Putting you on the spot.
27-1. No, I can't see that happening.
Is that the record for the Inferno season long?
Maybe, except they don't play that many games.
Well, including the playoffs.
And yeah, maybe. As long as that one's not the final, right?
Doesn't matter how many you win if you lose the last one.
Hey, I like the way that one sounds, yeah. So we are getting set for third period action. If you are just joining us live on CWHLLive.com or simulcast on CWHLLive.com/listen, our game is underway. We're getting set for the third period action here at the Joan Snyder Arena. Score is 6-0 in favor of the Calgary Inferno on 39 shots to the Boston Blades, 14 shots. Lacasse down in front of us here, end-to-end action with Delaney Bryan at the opposite end of the rink here. Center ice there is Sarah Davis and number 24, Christina Brown, as Davis with the win. And trying to get it through, knocked down by DeMasi and dumped in long as we're well underway here now in the third period. As that one's kept in the Inferno zone. As action now, Inferno trying to clear it up and out, trying to find Turnbull, does so over to Kirio. Davis keeping it in at the half boards there. Down low for Kirio, battling along is Burns. And kick him. And Cunningham grabs it, unable to hang on to it. Brown now with it for the Blades as she skates up over her own blue line, lifting up high. And in, icing waved off there. As the Inferno clearing it up and out of their zone. Cunningham trying to get it in neutral ice on the back end. Unable to do so as the Blades looking to apply some pressure. Now they do it, rink-wide pass there, just missing Campbell. Campbell now in the break on the backhand. Watchhorn sweeping that one out of the crease, just saving another goal there. It would have been Campbell's third of the night.
Hard to get the hat tricks on the ice here, though.
Can't get hats on the ice here. I don't see a lot of people wearing hats in the stands, so probably a good thing.
Well, the ones I see are ones that they just bought today, so I don't think you want to get rid of them yet.
You never know. As we got a minute 35 gone in the third period here. Watchhorn for the Blades back behind her net, skating out in front, up over her blue line, knocked off her stick by Haig. Tremblay with it now, trying to clear it in neutral ice as it's there. And number 17, Gray for the Blades, dumping it in, easy save for Brian. Battling at the far end of the rink. In the corner is number 23, Shea, for the Blades. Loose puck trying to get out front. Can't convert on that. And streaking down the right wing now. We've got Sonia dropping it back for Wickenheiser. Couldn't get that past Lacasse. That would have been Wickenheiser's first as a CWHL rookie player. As Aoki with it now for the Inferno. Back around behind her net. And unable to keep it in at the blue line. As Wickenheiser comes in, fakes the shot, hangs onto it, high slot, pushing down low for Esposito. Esposito battling behind the net, trying to get it off Duncan's stick. As Keefe off the boards, up and out, center ice there for Lovell. As that's over for Jenner, back down for Lovell. Lovell skates in down the left wing. Now down behind the icing line, centering pass, nobody home there in the slot area. Aoki
from the point, shot wide to the left of Lacasse as Boston manages to get it up and out over center ice as they dump it in and off on a line change as the Inferno with it now behind their net. 6-0 is your score. Calgary Inferno, 16:43 in the third period. Duncan hanging on to it, getting the shot off and stopping that. Sorry, that was Kickham. Stopping that was Delaney Bryan. Keep it a scoreless game.
Delaney Bryan hasn't been faced much, but she's still got 16 shots against. Had to be solid on a few of them, and a couple ones that easily could have snuck in between the pads and the post if she wasn't tight on the bar.
As faceoff coming to the right of Bryan. And one by the Inferno as behind the net. Level with it now up to center ice. Esposito knocked off her stick now as Kickham trying to put it out front, trying to get something on Bryan. Can't do so. Esposito losing a handle on it. Watchhorn keeping it at the blue line. Shot at the opposite end of the rink here. Behind the Inferno, centering pass. Doesn't make it out front there as it's number 24, Brown with it for the Blades, battling in the corner with Crom. Far end of the rink, off the boards. Watchhorn steps from the shot off the stick of Esposito. Esposito with it now, 2-on-1 here, breaking down the left wing. There's Lovell. Lovell with it now. High shot off the helmet of Lacasse and up into the netting. As
that may turn into a souvenir for someone, depending how it falls.
That would have been
wedged in there.
Wedged in the net. That would have been a great GoPro shot. Yeah, probably taken off the camera had it been mounted on the top.
Yes, it definitely could have.
And this faceoff now coming to the right of Lacasse as the officials grab a new puck. And we got Giannino in the faceoff circle with Davis. And one by Boston as back in the corner here. Shot around the boards by Myers. Over to Murphy on the right wing, trying to get it up and out. Does so to center ice. Webster standing there right at center ice, hanging on to it. Skating through, bringing in over the Boston blue line. We got another offside call here, shockingly. Just the second icing call of the game. Lots of high-paced, fun action here at the Joan Snyder Arena. 15 yep. bucks a game.
Yes, there is, and we are now live on Periscope right now as we get a little view inside the broadcast booth to see what goes on behind the scenes. So, of course, you can follow us, calgaryinferno.ca/periscope.
And faceoff. Marshall. Faceoff just outside the Boston zone there. As Boston skating away with it now up the left wing, and dumping it down. Bryan now behind her net, holding it there, leaving it there for Webster. Webster with it, circling back. She is being heavily pursued by number 15, Myers. And trying to stretch that pass out to Kirio. Can't quite connect on it, Lacasse. Oh, out of her net. Kirio was looking for a player, but nobody home there as it went right through the crease. All the way around now, Murphy with it, lifting it up and out into neutral ice for the Blades as Cudmore with it back. And Aoki with it now behind the net, skating up, trying to get down the left wing. Can't clear it out. Boston hanging on to it. The shot coming high over Delaney Bryan, held in at the left point by Watchhorn as she lifts it up. And that one's in the rafters, up into the beams.
And definitely an interesting perspective for our followers here to see from our view here. I don't mean the view of you, of course.
Oh. Well,
but
yeah,
the view of us here is...
When you look out
we'll
here...
We'll flip the camera. I'm there, too, now. So, yes, you can see... See out here, you can see the view that we get from the broadcast booth. Thank you for following us on Periscope.
And that faceoff won by the Inferno. 14:37 left in the third period here. As the Inferno looking to escape their zone with it through the skates of Jessica Campbell, looking for her hat trick on the night. Campbell behind the net, taken in by Watchhorn. Watchhorn and Campbell going down. Cunningham and Burns down there. Keefe with it now. Picked up by Bram, who really picks Keefe's pocket there. Over to Cunningham, inner skates, couldn't convert on that. As Shea knocks it up and over to the left wing for Keefe. Skates over the red line, trying to get in and around Aoki. And dumps it down. Her defensive partner, Takauchi, with it over to Campbell. Campbell looking to connect with Cunningham. And it's out of her reach as it bounces down. And Lacasse harmlessly steers it off into the right corner there. As it's Tremblay with it for the Blades, pushing it around St. Germain. Wickenheiser trying to pick it up. Wickenheiser in the slot area on the backhand, trying to skate around. Looks up to the point, nobody there. Tremblay and Wickenheiser battling in the corner as Hag comes in to try and help out. Up to the point, shot wide to the right of Lacasse. Around the boards, Pieri sneaking in Can't keep it in as it sneaks up and out as Brown with it. Can't hang on to that now. Hag with it for the Inferno. Up to Wickenheiser. Wickenheiser coming in down the left wing looking for a pass over on the half boards there. Pieri now up at the right point. Dumping it down low for Hag, just over her stick, hanging onto it though, as Burns down there. Down to Wickenheiser behind the icing line in the Blades zone. Battling off Brown. Two Blades players on her as Hag with it now. Over to Sonia putting it out front. Couldn't convert on that was Wickenheiser as the Blades trying to clear their zone. 12:50 left in the third period here. 6-0 the score, Calgary Inferno. As tired Blades players falling all over the ice. And the Inferno with it now in their own end. Looking for a rink-wide pass broken up by Watchhorn and dumped in. We got an icing call. 12:34 left in the third.
Well, you're complaining about not enough icing, so there was another icing for you. They did that just for you.
It's got to have something to do with cupcakes, I'm sure. All that icing.
Yes. Well, of course, there was the famous Twitter cupcake bet that we're still waiting on the final results to be announced, but always some good fun there, and our fans definitely supported us that with buying up those season tickets at a rate we've never seen before, which was fantastic.
As that faceoff won by the Blades, back up high slot area, and Watchhorn from the point, shot saved by Brian, and a rebound, and there's a goal as the Boston Blades have broken Brian's shutout with 12:24 left in the third period here, and you can hear that bench going crazy. Trying to figure out, I believe, that's Megan Myers that got that one on the rebound.
Yeah, big shot by Tara Watchhorn and that rebound by Myers, who smacked it in behind Delaney Bryan there to give the Boston Blades some life. And at this point, you may not think you can get back in a game, but you know you can score quick and you can score in bunches and you can get the momentum to lead into tomorrow's game. And an early start, anything could happen.
8 a.m. puck drop here at Jones Snyder tomorrow. Of course, we got another 12 minutes and 10 seconds worth of hockey to get through, as well as the Boston Pizza Motel Village postgame show. Be sure to join us, CWHLlive.com/listen for that one, as the Inferno not getting back on their heels here, trying to apply pressure, is level with it now. Down for Jenner. Jenner high slot over to Esposito, and an amazing sprawling save by Lacasse there, falling on her back, keeping this one interesting. You heard the crowd there. And you heard Jeff laughing as well.
Well, it wasn't really a laugh. It was so much as holy cow.
Yeah, you need to call
the police.
No
allusion to the Canada Dairy Farmers, but holy cow, that was one heck of a save. That's going to be on the highlight reel for sure, as Genevieve Lacasse didn't want that momentum her team gained by scoring that goal to go away. She said no.
And this faceoff won. Jenner trying to step around Keefe, unable to do so. As Boston now, Shea off the left wing, trying to bank it off the boards around Cumbord, does so. A little out of her reach though. Brian circling it around. As the Blades battling with the Inferno. As definitely Genevieve Lacasse keeping Boston kind of close in this now. As Jenner with it down low here. Jenner hanging on to it. Can't hang on to it long enough. Shea trying to bank it up and out. Can't do so. Aoki with it. Aoki now shot, glove save by Lacasse to get a stoppage of play here with 11:06 left in the third period. 6-1. 6-1. I almost messed that up. 6-1's your score now.
6-1. Shots 44-17.
Calgary Inferno.
Yes, it is. And with that, don't forget you can get all your CWHL merchandise at CWHL.ca.
And faceoff won by the Inferno. Shot from the point. Takauchi off a bunch of bodies harmlessly into the corner there. Trying to clear it up and out. As Burns does so over to center ice there. And St. Germain trying to get in on Aoki. Picks her pocket, but can't get the shot off on net. As trying to clear it up and out now. Brown with it for the Blades, circling around. And her pocket picked by the Inferno. At the opposite end of the rink here, as Turnbull pushing it down into the Blade zone here. Tremblay has Curio on her. St. Germain with it now up the left wing into the skates of Bram. Neutralized territory. Pieri with it. Gary off the boards. Tremblay there to pick that up. Steps into the blue line. Can't make any moves to get around the Inferno player as Bram loses a handle on that. Bringing it in onside is Crom. Dumping it down low. Cunningham with it now behind the Boston net. Tremblay with it. Bram and Tremblay. As Murphy taking it up over center ice, her pocket picked quite handily as Watchorn with it now. Trying to make a move, trying to get something more going for the Boston plays. Breaking it down the left wing and steered wide around the net. Out front for Giannino, but can't get on that as Campbell coming in down the left wing. Campbell loses the puck as it's knocked off her stick. And DeMasi knocking that one out. DeMasi with the puck on the left wing now. Brings it in and just picked out of her pocket by Sonia coming in from behind. As Blades trying to apply some pressure, 9-10 left in the third period here. Wickenheiser with it. Hard centering pass there for Hag, kept in by at the blue line by Webster. Bouncing puck, Wickenheiser with it now. On the left wing, circles back in a high slot. Shot low, Lacasse with an easy save. Saw that one all day long. 6-1's your score, 8:57 in the third.
And with that, CWHL and the Calgary Inferno wish to express thanks to our sponsors, the Canada's Dairy Farmers, Scotiabank, Sportsnet, Winsport, Bauer, Tim Hortons, Toyota, Molson Coors, the Globe and Mail, and Bridge Force.
And Kiefen Wickenheiser in the faceoff circle to the right. Wickenheiser with the win, stepping up there. It was Takeuchi, and the shot from her knees, Wickenheiser, as the fans signal field goal is good, as that one went over the net high and into the netting. Would have been a great
field
goal.
That one is sitting on the ground there for a lucky fan who seems to be running down beside us right now. We'd also like to thank Porter, Gong Show Gear, OMGs, the Calgary Flames, the Toronto Maple Leafs, the Montreal Canadiens. We'll pick it up later.
And Kiefen Wickenheiser, the faceoff outside the Boston zone. Aoki with it for the Inferno now. Back over to Takeuchi. Back in her own end. Trying to get up through the neutralized territory. Can't. As Boston keeping it in there. Burns with it. Over to Tremblay now in front of the player benches. Off her stick there. Takeuchi with it. Missing her defensive partner, Aoki, who skates for it. And Sonia can't hang on to that as it's dumped back in. Shea in pursuit. Takeuchi with it up to Wickenheiser. Wickenheiser over to, looks like Hag, yep. Number 16, yep. That number didn't change.
Nope.
As back behind the net is number 16, Duncan for the Blades. Trying to get it out off the boards. Can't do so. Lovell hanging onto it, keeping it in there. Circling back, Keefe. Keefe over to Watchorn. Watchorn up the right side. And left wing pass over to Shea, but picked up by Pieri. Watchorn now with it, neutralized, trying to get it through, trying to get something going. Keefe. It's in the skates of Pieri, who picks it up over to Crom and over to Esposito. Esposito makes a spin move around the player at center ice and comes in just offside as Jenner was a step ahead for a stoppage of play with 7:45 left in the third period.
Well, some of that shifty stick work that Esposito has displayed in her rookie season is back for the sophomore year. A good sign for the Calgary Inferno and her talented stick work.
As this faceoff in front of the Boston bench, won by the Blades. As back over to DeMasi now. DeMasi knocked off her stick. As Esposito with it at center ice. Esposito trying to come in. Coming down the right side there. Dropped it off for Jenner, who missed that one. And lucky sevens, Burns and Esposito going for the puck. Jenner with it now. Down low, DeMasi, Burns. Burns lifting it up and into the netting. From her end, from her own end. No delay of game penalty on in this league, right?
No, there still would be. They must have ruled that it was not clean off. It must have deflected off the glass a little bit or off another Boston player's stick. Either way, face off to the right of Genevieve Lacasse.
Now it looks like we got Davis and Brown in the faceoff dot.
Late change coming here by the Inferno.
Here we go.
They're going to talk to the ref, I think, about just that penalty, and that's exactly what happened there. As you were right, you did get it.
We have that recorded too. I was right. As it looks as though it's going to be number six Aaron Kickham going off, 2 minutes delay of game there. Another power play for the Inferno here, looking to capitalize as Wickenheiser won that one. Pieri back up at the blue line. Wickenheiser with it now. High slot area, shot low down. And Davis on deflection, but Lacaze with the pad save there. And Brown getting it up and down the length of the ice to relieve some of that pressure against the Blades. Yeah, skating down the right wing now. Pieri with it, down low. Campbell over to Wickenheiser. Wickenheiser back up to Pieri. Pieri down to Davis. Davis looking shot. Down low to Campbell, rotating around. Campbell, high slot there. Couldn't get it through. Off the stick of Watchorn. Campbell back up to Pieri. Pieri over to Wickenheiser. Wickenheiser fakes a shot. Brown on her. Up to Pieri. St. Germain getting an active stick there, managing to knock it out with a minute left in the power play for the Inferno. That power play, of course, coming to the Blades on a delay of game to number six, Kickham. As the Blades and Inferno battling at the opposite end of the rink there, skating away with it now is number 17 there, over to Davis now, as Bram back on that puck, back up to Cudmore at the blue line. Cudmore skates off the boards, down low to Campbell, bouncing puck, couldn't settle that down for the shot, fans on it, Tremblay up to the blue line, Cudmore holds it in there, down for Sonier. Sonier trying to center it, couldn't do so. Cudmore with a
sprawling
save to keep it in the Blade zone. There's 20 seconds left in the power play. Over to Esposito, back up to Cudmore. Cudmore down. Sonier shot. Pad save by Lacaze, who saw that all day long. Sonier holding it in. 10 seconds left. Down low to Turnbull. Turnbull back up to Sonier. Over to Cudmore. Slap pass over Turnbull. Turnbull getting the shot. Esposito open in front. Couldn't connect on that one. And that is going to do it for the power play. Equal strength here as Turnbull with a one-touch pass. And Lacaze standing tall on that one. Turnbull down low, up to the blue line. Cudmore, long shot. And Lacaze giving up the rare rebound. And nobody there to put it in for the Inferno. Cudmore again from the point, putting it through to the left of the net. Sonier trying to get it out front, can't do so. Watchorn lifting it up, lifting it out and down. No icing on this one. Aoki with it for the Inferno. 4:44 left in the third period. 6-1's your score, Calgary Inferno over the defending Clarkson Cup champion Boston Blades. As Calgary trying to apply more pressure here. Campbell on Burns. Campbell looking for that hat trick on the night. As five players battling for it down low in the opposite right corner. It squirts loose and Lacaze covers that up with the blocker glove before giving a little extra tug to Bailey Bram there.
Well, teammates on the national team when the gold medal was won in Sochi, Bram did not play any games there, but was with that team, no stranger to Genevieve Lacaze, who was probably having a little bit of fun, but also protecting her crease as well.
Yeah, absolutely. This faceoff is coming to the right of Lacaze. Giannino and Bram. Bram with the clean win on that one. Over to Cunningham, back up to Aoki at the point, dumping it in down low behind the net. Campbell with the puck, circling it around. It's held into the point. Hey, Takeuchi with the long shot wide. Bram with it down low now. Campbell's putting it out. Takeuchi with the shot, and a redirect by Cunningham, and Lacaze with the blocker save into the corner. Over to Aoki. Aoki's long shot low, looking for a sprawling Bram. Couldn't connect on that one. As DeMasi with it. Pushing it out, can't get it out. Cunningham skating down low. Inferno off on a change. Cunningham and Bram. Cunningham pursued by Burns. Up to the point now as Pieri holds it in. Rink wide over for Crum. Back down low to Cunningham. Cunningham high slot shot. Pad save, rebound, shot by Bram. Pad save again by Lacaze. To keep it 6-1 for the Inferno. Bram with it now. Over to Crum. From behind the net, up to Pieri at the point, over to Crom, up through the legs of Wickenheiser as it bounces out of of the zone, yeah, and retreating back to grab it now in her own end is Crom. As the Inferno, long stretch up to Wickenheiser, down the right wing, Circling around the back of the net there. Watchhorn on her. Of course, no strangers there either. Hag on the backhand. Blocked by Duncan. And Lacasse pulling that one out of somewhere keep going.
The Toronto Blue Jays might have been able to use her on the first baseline a few games ago with a catch like that one, eh? Hey, hey.
I'm
distracted.
Yeah, I am a little distracted as I'm just making sure that our supplies are ready for the Boston Pizza Motel Village post-game show. As we're back.
Good enough reason to be distracted.
Yeah, back underway here. As Hag with it now, battling down low, trying to get it around, trying to get something out. Watchhorn over to Gore, who gets it up. Webster holds it in at the blue line. Can't get it through traffic, though. Gore was all over that. But Hag with it now. Hag down low, looking for Wickenheiser, broken up by Watchhorn. Wickenheiser and Watchhorn in the corner here. Shea with it now for the Blades, skating up down the left wing, dumping it over center ice. Cudmore picking that one up easily. 2 minutes left in the third period here. Cudmore behind her own net. Up the right wing, over for Sonia. And Shea now for the Blades, looking to put it out front. Doesn't make it through as Cudmore broke that up behind the Inferno net. And opposite side of the rink here. And in action, Joan Snyder. Far right corner. Wickenheiser down there. Clears it around the boards for Webster. And Webster up off the boards and out. But it's Brown trying to get it back in. Webster still there. Webster and Brown tangled up in their feet. Brown knocks it back in. But back to grab it though is number 24, Haley Cudmore. And dumping it down, Tremblay. Davis in hot pursuit there. As Tremblay trying to get that around, unable to do so. Delayed offside there as the players get back onside. Takeuchi knocked that down just slightly while she was out. Inferno applying pressure here as we've got 1 minute left in the third period. Calgary Inferno leading the Boston Blades by a score of 6-1. Don't think we're going to see an empty net on either end of the surface here.
I would not imagine so.
I remind you to stay tuned for the three stars of the game, as well as our Boston Pizza Motel Village postgame show. As the Inferno still trying to apply some pressure, Turnbull down low. Turnbull at the half board, skating out in the slot area, makes a move around, backhand, can't get a handle, shot through, loose puck down, and there's Rihanna Kyrios, first of the season, to make it 7-1 for the Calgary Inferno here with 32.4 seconds left. Huge effort there by Blair Turnbull.
Nice stick work and patience by Blair Turnbull getting that one to net. Rihanna Kyrios sneaking in from behind, was there already sitting on the crease, pretty much just waiting for that puck to trickle through. And Genevieve Lacasse is going to have a question or two about that with the officials. Although I don't know that she's got too much of a case here because she wasn't interfered with. She wasn't prevented from getting that puck, but definitely some frustration on her part. 56 shots against her, so a 49 save performance. Still time to get 50 here.
This is a football score if you look at those shots. 56-17 as Boston winning it. And back to Watchhorn, over to Duncan, looking for the long stretch pass.
CFL score with the single?
7-1, yeah. We got a rouge going on? No, that's a safety, I guess, touchback on that.
Yeah, that would be two.
Yeah. As Jenner with it now, behind her own net, over to Crom, and Crom up.
As time is about to expire here, we have a 7-1 final. Reminder, stay tuned. We still have a half-hour show coming up after the game. The Boston Pizza Motel Village post-game show. 7-1 is your final. Shots 56-17. We will have your three stars coming by momentarily. And then we will have Sean downstairs with a couple of players for interviews before we head to our Boston Pizza Motel Village post-game show.
Say that 27,000 times fast, right?
Well, how many slices in a pizza are we getting?
Yeah, I don't know. It depends on who all is joining us as well for that.
Well, we know for sure we will have head coach Scott Reed. He will join us at some point on that post-game show every game, so you always can hear comments from the head coach of your Calgary Inferno here on CWHLLive.com.
You know, you look at the shots that period, and again, the ice definitely slanted. When you look at that, the Boston Blades only getting three shots off in the third period compared to a total of 17 for their shots on the game. Most of those coming in the middle period there in the second
yes.
period. Trying to do some mental math here. As it was 25 shots.
And tonight's third star from the Calgary Inferno, number 27, Jill Saunier, in her rookie debut. Second star from the Boston Blades, number 33, Genevieve Lacasse. And first star from the Calgary Inferno with two goals tonight, number 20, Jessica Campbell. Those are your Tim Hortons three stars. As we get ready here, we're going to take a quick commercial break to thank our sponsors, and we'll be right back with some interviews downstairs.
When I was seven, I wore these gloves. They held this stick. Well, these skates carried me over the blue line.
We won the championship. And now, it's all yours.
Cool. Oh,
and this mouth guard.
I'll get my own. Thanks.
The fifth seat. Hey. 100% drive. 100% passion, 100% effort, but women in sports get only 5% of the attention. Hey! Canada's dairy farmers believe women in sports should be seen and heard loud and clear.
All right, so we are just standing by as we get set up downstairs. Sean, you are with the goal score for the Boston Blades there. Number 15, Megan Myers. Take it away, Sean. Hey, Sean.
Thanks very much, Jeff and Marshall. Yep, standing here with Megan Myers, the individual who got the Boston Blades on the board tonight. And Megan, you guys played a much better game, I think, in the second half of hockey here. So you have momentum going into tomorrow's game. What do you think the team needs to do differently?
Yeah, I think we improved every period. Every shift we got better, and we were working a lot harder, trying to wear them out for tomorrow. But I think we need to work helping out Genevieve. She's our star. She's holding her own back there, and we just need to give her a little bit more help on the D end. Once we get the puck out, I think we'll be able to hold our own up there in front.
Well, thanks very much, Megan. Look forward to seeing you guys back on the ice tomorrow.
Sweet.
Best
of
luck. And Jeff and Marshall right now, going to be joined by the number one star for today's game, Calgary Inferno's own Jessica Campbell, who should just be coming on in just a moment. We're going to talk about what went right for the Inferno and what they look to do tomorrow, continue on this momentum in the second game of a two-game set with the Boston Blades, which, of course, will go tomorrow at Jones Snyder Arena here at Winsport at 8 a.m.
So, Sean, you got to see it from down there as you get ready there for Jessica.
She's here right now.
Excellent.
I don't want to cut you off, yeah.
Well, Jessica can cut me off anytime there. Go ahead. You scored two goals.
Jessica, great game for you today, two goals. How important was it to have such an explosive display for the home opener for the Calgary Inferno?
I think it was a long time coming for us. We've been practicing for a few weeks now, and excitement was building up, and I think once we hit the ice, we were ready to go, and I think it showed tonight.
Now, you know, 7-1 is a very decisive victory. Is there anything that you saw on the ice tonight that you would like to improve on for yourself or the team going into tomorrow's 8 a.m. game?
Yeah, I think just being sharp all over the ice. I think it's tough when you get ahead and to stick to your game plan. And we have to respect that Boston's going to come out tomorrow and, you know, want to get it back against us. And especially in our D-Zone, I think we can clean that up and just make sharper passes and play our game the full 60 minutes.
Well, Boston's definitely going to come out tomorrow to play, but right now, as you can see, a large group of fans have come to see Jessica Campbell and the rest of Calgary Inferno, so thank you very much. I'll let you get to them, and we look forward to seeing more of you guys on the ice.
Thank you very much.
Jeff Marshall, back up to you.
Well, Sean, we wanted to keep you there for one second
perfect.
There, too. You had a different perspective of the view down there at ice level.
I did, yes.
You get to really see and feel the speed that's out there on display. This was your first women's hockey game. What were your thoughts?
Yeah, my very first CWHL experience, and I have to say I was blown away with the explosive nature of the action on the ice. You know, the Calgary Inferno, we've talked about a lot, is such a stellar team heading into this 2015-2016 season with names like Jessica Campbell, Brianne Jenner, and, of course, Haley Wickenheiser. And that showed here tonight. As I, you know, when I talked to Megan Myers earlier, you know, Boston came on quite strong midway through the second period and continued that into the third. You know, they've got momentum kind of going now with that first goal. Obviously, Calgary, you know, got it back within the last minute. But overall, it was a great experience. Really good hockey to come and check out. And so if you do have a CWHL team in your market, highly suggest you get out to the ice and see what it's all about.
And you got a chance as well. Obviously, the three stars of the game had to stand out there. Genevieve Lacasse standing on her head. Campbell with the two goals. And Sonia had a great game across the ice as Marshall's on. You're trying to arrange our pizza from the Boston Pizza Motel Village for our post-game show here. Sean, who else stood out for you on that ice?
Well, you know, I think, you know, Jill Saunier, of course, as you mentioned, she got everything going. But more so to that, Bailey Bram, getting that second goal really helped to push open the floodgates because you saw those two other goals to end the first period came quickly after that. So I think, Bailey Bram definitely had a big game for the Calgary Inferno here tonight.
Yeah, you definitely noticed her on there mixing it up with Genevieve Lacasse at the end.
Yeah,
still not pronounced that right. I'm sorry, Marshall. I know you're trying to correct me on that. And
Genevieve.
Genevieve. Sorry to Genevieve Lacasse. Well, I will get it right for tomorrow,
yeah,
I promise.
Jeff, good news. There's a game tomorrow morning, 8 a.m., so I'm sure you'll have another crack at it.
I'm sure I will. And 49 saves on her behalf tonight.
Unbelievable
performance by her. Wasn't really beat on a straight shot all night. Everything was a rebound, was a cross ice pass there. So something that obviously Boston's going to try and do is clear the crease for her and clear out the streaking winger on the far side. Anything else that you think that Boston's going to try and do to get even in this series tomorrow?
Well, I mean, the big thing Boston needs to do is to get more shots on net. I think they finished with, as I can see from here, just under 17 shots over the night. And they need to get more pucks on the net, obviously. And to do that, they're going to need to break out of that defensive zone that Calgary held them in for most of the evening. So I'm looking for a more explosive Boston team to come out on the ice tomorrow and really take it to the Inferno.
Excellent. Well, thank you very much, Sean. Welcome to our team here at Calgary Inferno and the CWHL. And we're glad you enjoyed your first game.
Thanks
very
much,
guys.
You
had a good show here with the Calgary Inferno tonight for sure.
Awesome. Thank you.
Marshall, we are just waiting by here as we're set to start the show. Shall we start our post-game show?
Yeah, I guess.
Well, let's get the graphics going then, shall we?
You have stuff going? Okay.
Oh, yeah, I've got some stuff.
Our pizza is going to show up. It's by no fault of Boston Pizza at all. It's our first time that we're doing this one. We had a little mix-up on where it was supposed to go and get there and that kind of stuff. So it's going to come. It's great because I'm hungry. I didn't actually have any dinner. I just realized that as we're standing here, while I'm standing here talking away, as you can tell on screen, I clearly need more pizza.
Yeah.
But yeah, we're thankful to our newest sponsor for the team there, Boston Pizza Motel Village. Of course, again, a reminder to fans, feel free. Maybe
keep talking.
Slide over here.
Yeah.
Fans, feel free to take in your ticket stub on game day and save 10% at Boston Pizza Motel Village right down the road on 16th Avenue. Again, that victory.
So we have to play one last thing here before we can wrap up our official CWHL live broadcast here. Another thank you to our amazing sponsors that make this all possible. And when we are done with that, we will be back for 30 minutes of Boston Pizza Motel Village post game action.
When I was seven, I wore these gloves. They held this stick. Well, these skates carried me over the blue line.
We won the championship. And now, it's all yours.
Cool.
Oh.
And this mouth guard.
I'll get my own. Thanks.
The fifth season is when spirit for the game gets passed down. That's why we're proud to support over 5,000 teams.
100% drive. Hey! 100% passion. 100% effort. But women in sports get only 5% of the attention. Hey! Canada's dairy farmers believe women in sports should be seen and heard loud and clear. With Fueling Women's Champions, we're shining a light on women athletes at every level. Hey! Join us. Hashtag champion her.
Kimmy, you do know that there's only 4 seasons, right?
Then how do you explain the way kids wish away the summer because we can't wait to play in the fall? Or how teammates often become best mates? Or how families happily vacation in Winnipeg in January because that's where the tournament is? So you see, Miss Woods, there is a 5th season, and it's the best season in Canada.
So you're talking about hockey?
Oh, it's more than just talking, Miss Woods.
Scotiabank is proud to support over 5,000 teams in Canada's 5th season. Énergie. 100% passion. 100% effort. Pourtant, les femmes n'ont que 5% de visibilité. Les producteurs laitiers canadiens croient que les athlètes féminines devraient être vues et entendues haut et fort. Avec Nourrir la passion du sport féminin, nous célébrons les athlètes féminines de tous les niveaux. Joignez-nous à Vive le sport féminin.
On behalf of the CWHL and the Calgary Inferno, we'd like to thank you all for watching tonight's game. This game is brought to you by Dairy Farmers, Canada's Fueling Women's Champions. Fueling Women's Champions is a movement dedicated to breaking down the barriers that Canadian women athletes face at all levels of sport. We'd also like to thank league sponsors Scotiabank, Sportsnet, Winsport, Bauer, Tim Hortons, Toyota, Molson Coors, The Globe and Mail, Bridge Force, Porter, Gong Show Gear, OMGs, the Calgary Flames, and the Toronto Maple Leafs, the Montreal Canadiens, and team sponsors, the Calgary Old Time Hockey Players Association, Alberta Athletic Therapists Association, Deckel Doctors, and Sockbox.ca. Stay tuned. Right after this message, we'll be bringing you the Boston Pizza Motel Village postgame show, where we'll hear from Inferno coach Scott Reed, eat some Boston pizza, and talk to the various players from the Calgary Inferno that stopped by to have a chat and a slice.
Turn up the heat. Here come your Calgary Inferno!
And welcome to the Boston Pizza Motel Village postgame show. My name is Jeff Stevenson. My guest here right now is Marshall Stevenson, the voice of the Calgary Inferno. We are coming to you live from Winsport here in the Joan Snyder Arena, as I'm still getting used to this computer system, but I'll figure it out eventually.
By the end of the season, maybe.
Well, you know what? That was what it took you to get play-by-play in the first year, so.
Game two was better than game one.
Yeah, it was.
It'll be the same tomorrow. Of course, make sure you do tune in. I know we're just starting postgame show. Less than 12 hours to go till puck drop.
Absolutely. I mean, you seem to be looking at how I'm dying here for some reason.
I'm just laughing. You posted this 22 minutes ago while hockey was playing.
Oh, so they obviously got on my Facebook with the computer then. So who knows what else was up there, but that's why you don't not sign out of your Facebook when you let your computer to the PA guy.
Yeah, there you go. All right, let's. What are we going to chat about first here?
So, Marshall, first of all, what we want to talk about is the game, obviously. 7-1 final. Shots were astronomically lopsided there, 56-17 for the Calgary Inferno. But this wasn't the only game going on now, was it?
Nope, there was another game going on further out east, of course, where the Brampton Thunder were hosting the Toronto Furies in their home opener.
Clearly it was the second intermission, then not the third intermission, that was 1-1, as that would be impossible score for that scenario, as we said, it was going into overtime.
Yeah, unless you were looking at the wrong score, I don't know. The score here was, the final score was a score of 3-2 as the Brampton Thunder notched their first win of the season over the Toronto Furies as well. Of course, Calgary Inferno with their home opener notching their first win of the season as well.
So a pair of home openers, a pair of victories for the home teams, both in action tomorrow. Calgary back here against Boston, 8 a.m. start. The Toronto-Brampton game is, I believe, in Toronto tomorrow and a little bit later on in the day, so not quite the early start that we get here, as you'll confirm that with me.
No, it's in Brampton.
It is in Brampton.
Yeah, in Brampton at 1:30 Eastern time, 11:30 Mountain time here, so our game will likely be done by the time their game starts. It will be done.
So, Marshall, as we wait for some of the players to get changed and join us here, there's a lot of new blood out on the team there. We obviously know about Breanne Jenner, the first-round draft pick. We know about Haley Wickenheiser. I mean, who doesn't? But some of the unsung additions in the offseason there. Kanea Aoki had a great game on defense today. Jill Sonnier picking up the third star, really standing out with her play in this game. Blair Turnbull with that excellent move in front of the net to buy time to set up Brianna Curio with the game's last goal to make it 7-1.
Can't discount Alana Lovell, who got the second goal of the game as well to I guess technically the game-winning goal in Lovell there. Had another chance at one and also picked up an assist, I believe, on a goal as well. So.
And it looks like we have our first guest in the Boston Pizza Motel Village Lounge before the pizza's even arrived here. She's a little disappointed, but she'll join us anyways, and we'll make sure she gets her pizza when it does arrive. Here is Kathy Desjardins returning to the Calgary Inferno. Let's welcome her to the broadcast properly here.
Hello.
Let's get you welcomed in here and make sure everyone knows exactly who you are.
Kathy Desjardins, goaltender, Loretteville, Quebec.
And there you are, Kathy Desjardins. Thank you for being our first guest on the Boston Pizza Motel Village postgame show. You had the best seat in the house down on the bench watching this team perform. What's it going to be like to have that much talent playing in front of you when you get your shot?
Well, it's good for us for practice because we're getting better as a goalie, of course, because there's a lot of talent. Defensively and offensively, like we can see, we scored a lot of goals today. I think it's just going to get better and better. But, yeah, it's going to be a great year. The girls on the bench was great, too, so I'm just excited for this season now, yeah.
And you had the year off. You had a break in the action. You had to move out to Kelowna for some things. You're back now in Alberta, still living up near Red Deer and Sylvan Lake now.
Yeah.
So you are very committed to this team, driving in an hour and a half or so every day for practice, every day for a game.
Mm-hmm. I've always been really, the 2 years I play, I lived in Red Deer. I was driving back and forth. Of course, winter is a little bit dangerous, but the coach are really flexible if there's a big storm. They tell me to stay home, or if you want to make it, be safe. I think I don't want to say lucky, but I work hard to be here, and it's my choice to live in Sylvan Lake and work in a gym over there. It's not, so when I come here, I never say I'm tired, I never say I had a big day, even if I work at 6 o'clock in the morning. You know what, like, we're lucky to play in this league, and we're just the future for our little girls, so just lead by example. This is an example of commitment, is to drive all that.
Excellent. And now you mentioned that you work in a gym. I know we've had conversations in the off season on your journey to get back to the Inferno. You're working very hard, not only to get in shape to be the goaltender that you were and know you can be going forward, but you also worked very hard at getting your CrossFit instructors as well, too. Is that correct?
Yeah, that's correct. When I was in Kelowna, I had a new sport. I work out at CrossFit Okanagan in Kelowna, and they got me in great shape. I'm better shape than I've ever been, I think. And it just get me into another kind of sport. And I was still missing hockey, and that's where I realized that, hey, if I feel healthy, if my head is there, why not coming back? Why not try? So I knew I could do nothing on the ice to get better because I had no ice time. The only thing I could do, it's in the gym, get better, get more in shape. And Scott, I talked to Scott a little bit over a summer. He said, if you're in shape in the gym, Kathy, and you can't follow the play, it's going to come back slowly, but it's going to come back.
And what's it like having a head coach who is a goalie and played at very high levels, played in the AHL? How's that for having support as a goaltender?
Well, I had Scott for 2 years as my goalie coach when I played before. And now when I knew he was a head coach, I was really excited. He gave me a lot of good cue during the game. He can be funny, but he can be really serious. He gives you a great little tip. He's really supportive, but he tells you when to work and when to focus. He tells you too. So some people think, oh, Scott's funny. Yeah, but he can be serious. He's a great head coach too. I never seen him as a head coach, and today he did a really good job. No panic, just keeping the team really, really calm and keep having fun. Even if anything happens, just keep having fun. This is a game. This is a fun game. So
excellent. Yeah. Now, Scott was on Fan 960 with Ryan Pinder this afternoon promoting the game. And one of the conversations that came up was, well, you're a goalie, so you must be a little bit crazy. And Scott kind of alluded that, no, he's in the 5% that isn't. What's your take on that?
Scott can be crazy, but like I say, he's such a great guy. He have a big sense of like, humor. That's how you say in English, sense of humor. Definitely. And he's always like open for anything. You need to talk with him. He's there. So that's why he's going to have a great career as a head coach. That's for sure. Yeah. But crazy? Maybe a little bit.
Speaking from experience.
Yeah.
So, Kathy, the question I'm sure everyone wants to know is, has he talked to you? Are you playing tomorrow? Is it going back to Delaney? Has that been decided or is it still up in the air?
It has been decided. On the bench, Scott asked me, how are you feeling in the practice? I'll be honest with you, I don't feel the biggest confidence ever. I've been more confident in this on the ice. That's true. But every practice, there's something coming back, and I'm like, this is coming back, it's getting there. So every practice there's something positive about it, and I told that to Scott today, and just after the game he told me, you're ready for tomorrow. So I get the shot tomorrow morning, early morning. It's okay, I work early in the morning. So I'll be used to it to get up.
Oh well, it's probably a good idea to have the person is used to getting up at 6 o'clock, 5 o'clock in the morning to play that game too.
That's for sure. But I'm not gonna lie, I'm a little bit nervous, and we just have to break the ice. I think the first game, the first shot,
well, I think
it's going to be the one.
I think nerves are a natural thing.
Yeah.
I've watched you play here previously 3 years ago, and I think we had the record of 6 games in a row where the first shot went in.
Yeah.
And we won a lot of those games. So even if it does go bad for you tomorrow on that first shot, you've come back from that before. You've got a lot of offense in front of you.
Yeah, and that's the thing. I believe in my team, and I know we have a team that can come back. Maybe 4 years ago in my first year with Alberta back there, it was hard to get back into it because we didn't have the offense we have right now, right? So I'm just going to do one shot at a time and keep focusing on things I can and control what I can control.
Yeah. Excellent. Well, Kathy, we wish you all the luck tomorrow. We know you'll do great.
Thanks.
We're happy to have you back in the team and with the organization, and you've got the lovely flaming hair to match the logo here. You had some fun with the kids on the ice there.
Oh, yeah, that was so fun. I tried to be a little cocky there, but they're talented.
Yeah,
right?
I saw them take the puck off you.
Yeah, and score.
Yeah, you got too far to your nap. No, don't do that tomorrow, and you're all good.
Cool.
But looks like we've got Erica Krom out there standing by. She had a very nice assist there. We'll let you take a break.
Thank you.
Can wait out there for the pizza and then enjoy compliments of the Boston Pizza Motel Village.
Thank you very much.
Post-game show. Thank you, Kathy.
Thank you.
That is Kathy Desjardins, goaltender for the Calgary Inferno, returning to action tomorrow in her season debut, getting the start against the Boston Blades. A game where we expect to see maybe not the sharpest short notice here, lots of sleep, or lack of sleep rather, as Erica Krom is going to get into our makeshift studio here, wearing her brand new jersey here. So let's start with that. Erica, what's it feel to be able to have that Inferno logo on your chest this year?
Well, I think it gives our team an image, you know? It's nice to have the Calgary on there. Yeah, we're from Calgary, but I mean, this logo is, this is what started this whole Inferno thing. So I think it's a sick logo. So it's good to have it here instead of smaller over here.
Yeah, we get to play Scotiabank up there, which is nice, and they help us out a lot. So
yep. It
gives them some placement from the fans viewing above the ice.
Yeah, for sure.
And Erica, you had a nice pass today, setting up a goal there, getting your first point after going back on defense. How did that feel for you?
Felt good. I mean, it was a pretty easy play. Like, Campbell made it real easy for me. She was wide open over there and just calling for it. So I didn't really have to do much. I skated and passed.
Well, you had to make sure you delayed and didn't go offside there, as there's two players, not just one, but two players tagging up there and did a good job to delay on that and keep that onside as well, too. A 7-1 win in the home opener. Got to feel good to set that statement early.
Oh, yeah. It feels really good. Yeah, it's awesome. Just got to keep it up, you know. Tomorrow we got to do the same thing and ramp it up for our games against the other teams as well, because we know there's a lot of competition out there in the league this year. So, yeah, we just got to keep the tempo up and play a full 60 minutes each game.
Oh, I just realized I totally forgot to introduce you properly here. So let's pull that up here for a second, just because we can. Oops, that's old number.
Brittany.
Not used to it. Not used to it.
Erica Crom, defense, Long Island, New York.
So, Erica, the switch from 8 to 7, from 7 last year, what's the reasoning behind the switch?
7 had never really been my number. I actually wore it for a good friend who had worn my number back in the day for me. It was just really 7 was for her. And, you know, I've worn it for 3 years, and Espo said, hey, do you still want 7? And I said, I think I've worn it enough, and 8's my family number. So, I mean, I was like, sure, let's just, you can have 7 kind of thing. But, yeah, they're both good numbers. Doesn't really matter.
So there's some meaning behind 8 then. It wasn't just, well, we'll go up 1 because
we'll get the number. Yeah, Grandpa's number. So,
okay.
Yeah.
Excellent. Well, it worked well for you today. Obviously, 1 game, 1 assist. Good start.
Good start for the team, yep.
Speaking of the team, you've got to turn around in a quick game tomorrow, 8 a.m., less than 12 hours from now, almost 11 hours from now.
Yep.
How do you make sure you get the proper rest, energy, recharge, and get ready for that game on that short turnaround?
Well, right now is the most important time. Proper cool down, stretch, roll out, the whole thing, eat right now. That's basically what we need to do and get a good sleep. I mean, it's rough to get up that early, but that's what it is, and there's no excuses, and we just need to be ready for it.
And now Genevieve Lacoste, 49 saves in that loss there. She really kept the Blades in this game. Could have been a lot wider margin of victory there for you. There seemed to be a game plan to beat her, to get the puck on the net, get the rebounds, or get it across ice, not to try and beat her straight on. Was that a deliberate plan by you guys?
Same game plan every game for any team, regardless of who's in net. Just getting pucks to net, grinding it out, getting the rebounds. We had a lot of really nice goals. We also had a few just rebound goals, and that's the kind of game we want to play all year.
And now maybe you can shed a little light on it. We obviously had the one goal where Campbell's first goal where it was in, play continued, and then the refs conversed, and it was ruled a goal.
Yeah.
Did you know it was in? Did you see it?
Honestly, I think I was drinking water and probably I didn't actually see the goal, but my whole team was cheering. So I just assumed, oh, we scored. But, you know, it's kind of awesome that the refs that we have will go back and actually talk about it, you know, and review it. And it's not just, oh, no goal. That's what he called at the beginning. So,
yeah, we were having a bit of a conversation up here because we weren't sure what they actually could do in that scenario. We knew there was no video replay, so even though we could have pulled up the replay here, it wouldn't have mattered for the ice. But the referee is doing the conversation thing.
Yep.
Someone obviously saw it go in from behind there, unable to make the call where it was. So it was great and a good job by officials that have probably the hardest job in the world.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Well, Eric, I see Coach Scott Reed is by here next to come in. So
awesome.
We will let you get to that important stage of getting ready for next game tomorrow morning.
Awesome.
And of course you're welcome to some slices of pizza do arrive here, thanks to Boston Pizza Motel Village on the Boston Pizza Motel Village postgame show.
Thanks, Boston Pizza.
Thank you. All right, that of course is Erica Crom, or the Crominator. It's throwing a body check earlier today, getting an assist, having a great game as the Inferno win 7-1, out shooting the Boston Blades 56-17. Joined now by the head coach, Scott Reed, getting his first official win as the official, no acting in front of it, head coach of the Calgary Inferno. How did that feel for you to get a win like that today?
I appreciate it. No, it was exciting. The girls played very well. You know, from start to finish, that was our first real test, first real game. So I'm proud of the way they showed up and battled all game.
And obviously Genevieve Lacasse was doing everything she could to keep you guys from scoring. Was there a deliberate game plan there to how to beat her?
Well, obviously she's one of the elite goalies in the world right now. And, you know, obviously you get pucks in traffic in front of a goalie at that caliber. That's one of the things I've learned is goalie can't stop what they can't see. So it doesn't matter how good you are. But, you know, she made some outstanding saves tonight. She kept them in it. And, you know, when it got down to it, it was really a 1-1 game in the third period.
Yeah, it definitely seemed like they were in it more in the latter half of that game there. An early start tomorrow, a quick turnaround on it. Does that favor you, the home team, or the visitors who are here with no nonsense, go home, go to sleep in the hotel, and get up and come to work?
I think it's a little bit of both. You know, both teams have the quick turnaround. They flew today, and then, you know, like I say, it's a quick turnaround, but you know, it's also our quick turnaround because that was our first real test, our first real game. They had back-to-back games already, so we just got to be prepared for tomorrow once puck drops.
And we've talked about Lacasse. On the flip side, Delaney Bryan had a pretty solid game in net, although she wasn't tested heavily, still faced 17 shots. What did you like in her game tonight?
You know, I thought she played well. She kept us in it early when we needed a couple key saves till we got our feet underneath us. You know, she's a great goalie. She makes that first save. She's in position to make the second save. I think we just got to, you know, the goal they did get was a little bit of a battling goal where we got to just compete in front, whether it's the goalie, D's, or forwards helping out. So, you know, that's got to be worked on a little bit. But other than that, all-around game, I thought she played very well for her first game.
Excellent. That is, of course, you're hearing right now from
Scott Reed, head coach, Grand Prairie, Alberta.
Mr. Scott Reed from Grand Prairie, Alberta, and his official head coaching debut today with a 7-1 win over the Boston Blades, the defending Clarkson Cup champs. Obviously a very different team from that team that won the Clarkson Cup champs. Tara Watchorn's another one of those key players that stayed behind there. Did she stand out for you tonight doing the things that she's always done?
Oh, absolutely. She's an elite player, and she's proven that at different levels now, especially even at the Olympic stage. You know, you got to be on her, and you got to watch her consistently throughout the game. She's a player that all of a sudden you're not really paying attention, she could do some damage. So they got a really good squad over there. People can't take them for granted. You know, they're young, they're fast, and they never quit. And that showed tonight. They never quit, even when they're down a few goals, they never quit.
Yeah, they definitely did pour it on towards the end, trying to get some momentum, get back in the game. Tomorrow's start obviously going to be crucial. You probably can't expect a 4-0 start after the first period again, but getting one or two would be key. You have some new players that joined in there. Who stood out for you as really making an impact in their first game in an Inferno uniform?
You know, obviously there's the likes of Breanne Jenner or Sonia or Turnbull. You know, they're young players. They're fast. They're quick. They're smart. They're very knowledgeable of the game. And, you know, those are the two up front that really, you know, kind of stepped up. But actually, you know what? All four lines did some damage tonight in different ways. You know, they competed, they supported each other, they were communicating, and I think that just helped us out when we got into some trouble.
And the one area everyone knows the firepower the Inferno have, the question has always come up is defense, and I think the defenders played a very solid game today. Some great plays at the blue line, keeping the puck in to stop the transition game. What did you like from your defensemen tonight?
Absolutely. You know, our D-core, you know, we don't have the big name right now, but we have a lot of steady Eddies. You know, they played defense their whole career, college, so they know what they're doing. We have two Japanese national team players. You know, they're very talented, too. It's just getting them comfortable with the surroundings, and I think they'll just get better. I think our D-core is one of those things that just, as time goes on, it's just going to get better and better. Yeah, you know what, they might not be the names of our forwards, but that doesn't matter. You know, we have our forwards back checking. They're going to help out our defense. And, you know, this is just going to work hand in hand to make our team overall better.
Certainly. And no game is perfect. There's obviously areas of the game that you look at and you say, okay, we could have done this better. We could have tweaked this. What were some of the things that you saw that you want to improve on?
You know, I think our maybe on the back end, you know, just staying in front of the puck, you know, don't letting their forwards get behind us, you know, keep the play in front of us. We've talked about back checking a lot, numbers coming back. So, you know, pick up players, but don't over back check, you know. There's a smart hockey player and a dumb hockey player when it comes to back checking. You get over back check and all of a sudden one pass beats to you because you're on one player. So we got to be smart back checking. And D-zone coverage, it could always be better, can always have some improvement there. So, you know, like you say, we won tonight. Score doesn't matter. It's a win. We have to come midnight. We're going to forget about it, and we're going to start preparing for tomorrow.
And obviously there was a great crowd out here tonight, not really a seat open upstairs, and some standing room filled up as well. What's it like to play in front of that type of full arena as opposed to what was like several years ago where it might have been more friends and family?
Yeah, no, absolutely. It's wonderful. The girls appreciate it a lot. They're very thankful for the work our marketing staff have done. You included is a big part of that. So thank you. That comes from the girls as well. Obviously, when you have fans to play in front of it, it's very exciting. It helps you get up, you know. They cheer and the girls hear it. And it just makes the atmosphere overall better for the fans and for the players.
So we had the special ceremony there. We might have got a little bit too crazy with the smoke. That caused a little bit of delay in the start of the game there. Had to do a little bit of the old skating around era, the old Stanley Cup with the Boston Bruins and the Edmonton Oilers way back when.
Yeah, that's okay. I played in South Texas, and we had to do it every 10 minutes because all of a sudden the fog's so thick that once the red, you can only see to the red line. If anyone was to shoot the puck down at you, you might be in trouble. You could score. So every 10 minutes, we did the old hot laps.
Keeps you in the game, eh?
Absolutely.
So, Scott, we won't take much more of your time here, but want to thank you for joining us in the Boston Pizza Motel Village post-game show. We are just waiting on our delivery. There was some conversational communication issues because Marshall's phone was ringing while he was doing play-by-play and couldn't answer. So
yeah,
the pizza will be on its way.
That's totally okay. We are thankful, and thank you to Boston Pizza. You know, it's a great supporter. And, you know, the girls very much appreciate it. And, you know, tomorrow 8 a.m.
Tomorrow 8 a.m.
Got to get everyone back out here to help support the team.
Yep, it'll be an early game, but it'll be a good game. Lots of action, lots of speed. That's the thing that I always take away from the game out here is there's so much speed on the ice with these players, and so much more finesse that maybe you don't see in the men's game, where you're more about the physical play.
Oh, exactly. You know. The women's game, I found out, you know, they're very smart hockey players. You know, they read plays, they read rushes, they support each other, and they're moving. You know, they're not hitting and pinning and, you know, F2 coming in to take the puck. You know, it's obviously there is some contact, and it's mostly along the wall. But, you know, they're moving, they're supporting each other, and they're getting that puck going the other way real quick.
Excellent. Well, Scott Reed, thank you again for joining us here. Congratulations on the win. Congratulations on removing the interim tag this season, and I'm sure you'll do well this year. Got a great team that has to make it more enjoyable to be a coach for sure.
Yeah, thank you so much for having me, and yeah, absolutely. Every day we're just going to go to work and get a little bit better.
Excellent. Well, that was Scott Reed here on the Boston Pizza post-game show. Once again, that was
Scott Reed, head coach, Grand Prairie, Alberta.
And we are going to quickly thank our sponsors once again, beyond, of course, Boston Pizza Motel Village here. That would be the Canada's Dairy Farmers Fueling Women's Champion Program for their valuable support in presenting CWHL streaming in 2015-16. We'd also like to thank league sponsors Scotiabank, Sportsnet, Winsport, Bauer, Tim Hortons, Toyota, Molson Coors, The Globe and Mail, Bridge Force, Porter, Gong Show Gear, OMGs, the Calgary Flames, the Toronto Maple Leafs, the Montreal Canadiens, and team sponsors, the Calgary Old Time Hockey Players Association, the Alberta Athletic Therapists Association, Deckel Doctors, and Sockbox.ca. Don't forget to check out CalgaryInferno.ca for all your Inferno action. We're going to take a short break, and we will be right back with some more Boston Pizza Motel Village post-game show.
Thank you. for Campbell. Looking to pass shot. There's your goal. Tying goal. Her second in as many games is Brittany Esposito. Up behind for Dion. Johnson manages it on the backhand, muscling around inside post to make it 3-all. League-leading scorer, Rebecca Johnston.
Well, here's the chance for Calgary. I'll get back to that in a moment. As they slash in and score. What a great finish. The Inferno make the most of that one.
Shot saved by Brian off the post there down.
To be honest, my angle, I thought it was going in.
Irwin watching that come over her shoulder. Centering pass to Johnston with a great one-time touch.
Out of the rebound, Roulette with it now, pushing it up to the point. Long shot, Cudmore, lead the rim. Deflection, I believe that was awesome. Did it go off?
Or a stick and tape to tape pass right over Sarah Davis.
Yeah, a lot of talent.
Roulette breaks through. Partial break here. Grom back. Shot can't get off. Amazing save by Brian Sproul.
Can't see a much nicer save than that.
Wise. Esposito. On the back end from Esposito. Just under the arm and in, making it Cunningham. All rebound given up. And Cunningham cleaning that up, making no mistake to give us a 2-1 score with a
pocket pick just inside the blue line there by Bram. And that scores! A great pass across.
Toronto with an early chance. Now Calgary trying to answer back here in overtime. They just over a minute. Rebecca Johnston in your circle. Skates, stick handles, takes it behind the goal.
Centers, and it's in! Cudmore finishes it off with the one-timer. Toronto pick up a single point, but Calgary come back after giving up two third-period goals and win this in OT.
As time has expired here, 3-2 is the final score. Calgary.
All right, we're back here on the Boston Pizza Motel Village post-game show. Back joined again with Marshall, who will cover up his face with the logo. We got a little bit of that still.
Yeah, the delay. I forgot about that. Yeah.
There's that delay there.
Yep.
So Marshall had some good conversations with Kathy Desjardins. She's getting the start tomorrow. It's confirmed. She was open and honest. She was nervous. She's nervous about getting back in net. She's not sure if she's ready, but you know what? There's only one way to tell if you're ready, and that's to get out there and do it.
And you know the Boston Blades are going to be hungry to bounce back from this 7-1 loss.
And they will. And you know what? I don't think it's a bad idea to go with Kathy either, because not only is it game two of the series, you don't go back-to-back in that short rest with Delaney Bryan, but you're going to someone who is used to getting up at 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock in the morning to go to work and work out and train people and do a physical job. So why not go with your most important position, your goalie, with someone who is used to being up that early and being physical? Not that Delaney Bryan wouldn't be good, but it's not a bad bet.
Yep. As a personal trainer, you know, she's up early dealing with clients, keeping in shape and really knocking things out at an early time there. So no doubt it'll be good. It'll be interesting to see as the season continues if the 1-1 goes for Delaney and Kathy there between the pipes getting alternate starts. No doubt that Coach Reed as well is busy looking to see how the players perform and evaluating and seeing if there is a true number one that leads out or not. Of course, two seasons ago when Kathy was here, she was number one and Delaney was the backup, and that transitioned partway through the year as well. And last year, of course, Delaney number one with Troutman as a backup. And so it'll be an interesting battle. It's always good to have that battle for top position with your goaltender.
Absolutely. And if Kathy Desjardins can return to the form of what she was two years ago, when she was with the Inferno, that's a good problem for Scott Reed to have, is when you have two goalies that can go in and give yourself a chance to win every single game. And that's what every coach wants, is that position to be solidified, and you work from the net on out and you're good. And we know and we've seen today what this offense can do, and that's still without leading goal scorer from last year, Rebecca Johnston, in the game. That's not with Megan Mickelson or Bridget Laquette on defense that are both coming later on in the season. This is going to be a dangerous team, a team to contend with. And if they continue to do the things that they need to do, if they continue to put in the work, they will be a tough team to beat. But if you get lazy and you rest on your talent, teams will walk all over you.
Agreed. Well, I do agree with you a lot, but yeah. You know what? I think we're going to wrap that up now.
Yeah, there's just one last quick conversation I want to have that we didn't have this morning. Obviously, captain's being named. Brand Jenner, captain. Rebecca Johnston, assistant. Haley Wickenheiser, assistant. Jackie Pierre, assistant. One of those players continued over from last year with the assistant, that, of course, being Rebecca Johnston. So a new leadership group here, a new coach, new direction. They want to win. They've got that set goal there. There is a clear statement with those captains there that these are players that have played at an international experience that have won and don't really accept losing.
You know, I like the players that have been appointed at that level. Of course, the only one without any of that international experience, Jackie Pierre. But when you, not that I've been in the dressing room, but when you hear about the dressing room and that kind of stuff, she's one of those ones that's always there, always cheering people on, always making sure everybody's getting to go, leading by example. And that time that she's put in with the team in the league, of course, a native of New Jersey, calling Calgary home for the last couple seasons and still continuing to do so. It's definitely true and makes perfect sense that she's now got that A on her chest.
Yeah, and I think you're bang on with that. Jackie Pierre is always that first person when there is a community event to go to, when there's a chance to promote the team, to promote the game, to grow the game. She is the first person in line with her hand up volunteering. And that translates exactly with what you said. And I know it translates on the ice in the dressing room too. She is one of those leaders there. Wick, how can you talk about her experience and not know that she's done it all? Johnston, we know what she can do. And Jenner has a great college career, a great international career, and now she's going to carve out a great CWHL career, a pro career as well.
Yep.
With that, let us wrap it up on the Boston Pizza Motel Village post-game show here today. Thank you to them for their sponsorship. Fans, if you come out to the game tomorrow, take your ticket stub, 10% off lunch after the game. Not a bad way to spend a Sunday.
And, of course, tomorrow's game puck drop is at 8 a.m. Mountain Time, 10 a.m. Eastern, and you can catch that at cwhllive.com/listen. And we'll be sure to be bringing you all the action from Joan Snyder here once again in Winsport at Calgary.
So once again, thank you very much to our sponsors and our fans. I am Jeff Stevenson. To my right is Marshall Stevenson, the voice of the Calgary Inferno. Have a good night, and let's play some hockey tomorrow.